left-footed kicker. We are underway. Deep, going to be taken by Shelton Gibson, and he will take a knee in the end zone. Kennedy, a very strong leg, so the Mountaineers will take over first and 10 as we take a look at Skylar Howard, the quarterback for the Mountaineers. 6 foot, 207 pounds. Dual threat as a runner and a thrower. You see his 2015 stats punctuated by a 532-yard performance in the Cactus Bowl as he comes out ready to lead his team today. He'll have Russell Shell out there with him and a four-receiver look for the Mountaineers.
Look for Skyler to probably get a couple quick throws to get him involved in the game and make sure those ribs are okay.
Did have a rib issue and had to leave the game briefly against Missouri. Hand off to Shell off the right side, bounces it outside. Shell trying to stretch things out, instead is thrown out of bounds around the 26-yard line. A pickup of one as Jameel Smith, the outstanding strong safety for the Penguins, leads the charge defensively.
Yeah, last week there wasn't too many throws down the field for West Virginia just because Missouri was playing that two shell and not given the opportunity. So we'll see what happens.
Howard back over the middle, complete to DeKeel Short. Shorts makes a man miss and stumbles across the 40 out to the 41-yard line. So Shorts, coming off a big game a week ago in which he had eight catches, picks up the first down.
Very nice quick slant throw there by Skyler, and that's where you want to put the ball, right on his chest.
Quickly to Shell. Shell finding some room off the right side. Russell Shell deep into Youngstown State territory, crosses the 40 down to the 38-yard line before Leroy Alexander can make the stop.
Really nice cut by Russell. Same with the slant. They seem to be attacking the middle of the field a little bit here with these split safeties.
Mountaineers moving quickly. Shell in motion. Howard back over the middle, and it is intercepted in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Durant, and it's picked off by Eric Thompson. And boy, Youngstown State coming up with a big first play of the game here, Mark.
Same exact route as they had on the backside, the slant on the inside, and just as I mentioned, he put the ball right on the money on the first throw. This one was a little ahead of him, and receivers sometimes, we call it alligator arms, they get that in the middle of the field. It certainly wasn't there, but that's what you have to worry about, leading them too much in the middle of the field for tip balls.
So a good start for the Youngstown State defense. Now the offense with Ricky Davis under center. And a drop now back with Ruiz as a sidecar to the left. And he'll keep trying to make one man miss, couldn't do it as Crawford came up, Antonio Crawford, to make the stop. And here's a look at Ricky Davis, who beat out Hunter Wells. Hunter Wells started every game last year, a fellow junior. Davis, a big guy, and Bo Pelini says he gives him the best combination of running and throwing. You can see the impressive statistics last week against Duquesne, both throwing the ball and running the ball. Stop for a loss there of three.
Really nice open field tackle there by Crawford there. There was a lot of running room if he didn't make that tackle.
Davis will go up now, pointing out the defenders for the Mountaineers. Back looking, has time, and now he'll tuck it and go. Crosses the 30 and dives out to about the 33-yard line, so gets back to the original line of scrimmage and a couple more.
Yeah, West Virginia went to a one-high safety look, which should be conducive for throwing, but Ricky did a really good job there. If it's not there, don't make the big mistake this early in the game. Just come down, get it to manageable third and seven or so, and I was impressed with that decision.
Third down. Two receivers split to each side. Mountaineers showing blitz. One on the play clock. Davis gets it off. Looks, now tucks it. Davis looking to get to the edge. He's going to get there. Crosses the 40, the 45, out to midfield. First down for Youngstown State.
Really?
And now a late flag coming in as a shove. It looked to me like Darian Townsend may be the culprit here for Youngstown State.
Really nice decision again by Davis there, taking it down and running. He got a good set of wheels. That was cover zero, we called it in the NFL, where there's no help safeties. That was all man-to-man. So these receivers have to get open for him, but at the same time, there's no one accountable for the quarterback there since it was cover zero.
17-yard run, but the officials here sorting things out. And you can see the flag getting tossed near the call now.
After the play, one on their offense. Great pick.
Automatic first down.
Just a mistake that kind of demoralized you. Just a great play by the quarterback to get that first down on third down, and to have it come back on just a foolish penalty is just demoralizing.
And that was Darian Townsend. By the way, the penalty flag was invented by Dyke Beatty, the original coach of Youngstown State. Back in 1938, the first coach, coached there from 38 to 72, invented the penalty flag. How about that?
Think
first and 10.
Learned that at Washington University.
Once again, Davis, the keeper, going feet first with the slide. He's going to pick up 11 yards and a first down for Youngstown State.
Yeah, West Virginia, Coach Gibson's going to have to make some adjustments here. They're still playing the single high, which should stop the run, but there's some big holes right now, and they're going to have to start accounting for this for Davis here.
Well, they love the way their tight ends block, and they have a very big offensive line, much bigger than you might expect on the FCS level. Now we have a stop and play as Eddie Shelton, the referee, coming to the line of scrimmage. And they're going to take a look at this. Well, again, the new rule, Mark, is that once you begin to go into the sliding motion, that's where the ball is dead. It used to be when you hit the ground and slid, but they're, you know, it's one of those player safety rules. So let's take a look at it here with Davis and where he goes into this slide.
Yeah.
Looks like a pretty good spot to me.
It looks like a pretty good spot. You know, I like that rule. If they want to protect the quarterbacks like they are, then you can't give them credit for that extra part of the slide. So what's it look like, about the 47 or so?
Well, they haven't marked it the 46. Yard. Again, it's where he goes into it, not where he hits the ground. To me, that looked like a pretty good spot.
Okay.
We'll see, though, what we think.
Yeah.
doesn't
matter up here. Huh?
Doesn't much matter, no. So if you're Bo Pelini right now, I think you have to be pretty happy, even with that penalty, to overcome that, pick up a first down here. They're getting Davis some running room, and he's been able to get a couple of first downs.
Yeah, I'm real impressed right now with what Coach Pelini's been able to do. West Virginia came out. Yeah, it still looks 46-47ish. They came out flying on offense right down the field, and then that interception kind of turned it around. And I mean, they've moved the ball pretty well. I know it's just been quarterback rushing, but these holes are pretty big.
Well, let's get the call now from Eddie Shelton.
The ball will be placed on the 44-yard line. The game. It will be second down.
Okay, so we were wrong. They're going to mark it back at the 44-yard line, and it's not a first down. Instead, it's a second and one.
So I guess it's when you start thinking about taking the slide, not even when you begin the slide.
So Davis has run the ball four times for Youngstown State. Now on a second and one. It's time he'll give to Ruiz, and Ruiz will pick up the first down out to the 46-yard line as we take a look at the players to watch offensively and defensively for Youngstown State and the Mountaineers. We talked about Ruiz in the running game, Darian Townsend, Alvin Bailey, a couple of talented receivers. Bailey is a Florida transfer, very inexperienced receiving group, and Noble Wachuku and Kaiser White, who had an excellent first game against the Missouri Tigers, part of the White family here at West Virginia.
Yeah, that last play didn't look like much, but you got to hand those balls off inside here and there just to keep West Virginia honest.
And a good time to do that. Short gain, you pick up a first down. Fake. Davis back, looking. He'll throw. And over the hands of Bailey, who's hit after the play by Crawford, but incomplete, so it'll bring up a second and 10.
Seems like there is two wide receivers for Youngstown State in the same area. If you miss, you got to miss high and wide on the sideline, and not too bad of a throw there.
Little bump after the play. The officials decide that's just football. Now trips to the left, receiver to the right. Once again, Davis will come to the line of scrimmage, change the play. Four on the play clock. Davis gets it off. Back, quarterback draw. And hit by Wachuku as he gets near midfield. The pickup of a couple will bring up a third and long.
Davis switched the play there. That was a design quarterback draw. Still playing a lot of single high. I think Youngstown State will be taking a shot here soon. It's don't want to get in these third and long situations too much if you're Youngstown State.
Third and eight. Justin Arndt, the linebacker, crowding the line of scrimmage in the middle of the field.
Running the play clock down pretty much every play here, trying to speed this game up.
Davis looking, throwing, and batted away. Good defensive play by Maurice Fleming, the fifth-year Iowa transfer. And Youngstown State will have to punt.
Yeah, West Virginia's DBs are all over Youngstown State's receivers right now. There's just really nowhere to go with the ball right now for Davis. And he's missing where he has to just because a foot behind there, and that's 6 points for West Virginia. So it's not always so bad taking a punt, as I learned from Coach Nealon years ago.
Mark Schuler back to punt it away. Banging kick. And it is going to land right at the end line and scoot into the end zone. So West Virginia will have the ball for its second possession after the 60-yard punt. No score at their own 20-yard line.
West Virginia's first drive, moving right down the field and made one little error and gave Youngstown State the ball.
Crawford and Shell, the split backs. It's Crawford in motion. Give the Shell off the left side. Russell Shell to the 25. Dragged down by Leroy Alexander out at the 28-yard line. Pickup of eight as we take a look at the players to watch for each team, with the Mountaineers having the ball offensively. Dekeel Shorts, you see the big numbers. Last week, Shelton Gibson, the big play threat on the outside. Derek Rivers, outstanding defensive lineman. He will have to be accounted for in this game. Complete to Kaiser White. I beg your pardon, Kayron White out to the 36-yard line. Karan White with the reception, part of the White family. Kaiser, his brother, playing on defense.
Cover two Shell there. Skyler Howard with a great job going across his progression and finding the open guy.
Here's Shell off the right side, and Shell is taken down after a short gain this time. And that's Avery Moss, Nebraska transfer, in the defensive end after a gain of a couple brings down Shell.
Seems like Shell's in the game plan for the early of the first quarter here. We haven't seen too much of Crawford yet.
Seems a little quicker this year. Mark, like, he's a little better conditioned senior year, maybe some urgency as well.
There is. You got 6-7 months from now, that draft coming, it gets that urgency going.
Crawford now the lone setback. To give to Crawford off the left side, and not much there. He stays on his feet, still moving. Well, Jamal Crawford, Justin Crawford, a very combative running back as he gets the ball out to the 45-yard line. Dana Holgerson really talking about his leadership skills since he's come in. Now they're going to mark it back at the, you know, between the 43 and the 44-yard line. So a gain of three, and it'll be third and about five.
It's a cover two look, and as a coach, you draw it up, and you're supposed to be able to run the ball versus cover two, so it's got to be a little frustrating for Coach Holgerson.
Our back, pressure. Throws out in the flat, incomplete. It was Derek Rivers. We talked about him, the preseason All-American, supplying the pressure. All-time sack leader at Youngstown State, and so West Virginia will have to punt it away.
Yeah, Rivers got in there really quick. You can see him. He actually got pushed off by the guard, it looked like, and lucky he didn't get a late flag there, but good job by Howard getting rid of the ball and living another day here with the punt.
Billy Kinney back to punt. Darian Townsend to receive. Kinney's punt floating. It'll take a very favorable West Virginia bounce and will roll out of bounds near the 10-yard line. So the Penguins still hanging in there. 8:21 remaining in the first quarter, scoreless at Milan Push, West Virginia. Second possession now for Ricky Davis and the Youngstown State Penguins. He'll fake to Ruiz, go over the middle, complete to Shane Kuhn, the tight end. I beg your pardon, that's Kevin Rader, who made the grab out over the 25, and another first down for the Youngstown State Penguins.
Good throw there by Davis. I'd like that ball down a little bit. The safety here, he came down and bit on the run. That could have went a long, long way if that ball was down a little bit, but nice completion.
Just enough to maybe keep that defense a little honest as well.
Sure, if that safety starts cheating, you're going to see a lot more of that.
It's Rader in motion. Give to Ruiz, finds a crease off the right side, and Jared Harper, nice shoestring tackle to keep the gain to about 3 yards.
You'll take 3 yards on first down all day. You know, you just don't want those negative plays where it's second and 12, second and 13, and then you don't have many plays to call from that. So I'm sure Coach Pelini's happy with, you know, how his offense is they keep getting positive plays, and that's all you want, especially when you're on the road and in this kind of an environment.
Second and a long six. Davis will give to Ruiz. Ruiz finds a crease off the left side and will get out across the 40 to about the 41-yard line. It's another first down for the Penguins before Jeremy Tyler can make the stop.
Yeah, Jeremy Tyler came up with a nice hit, but these holes, Coach Gibson's got to be a little bit concerned. They're pretty big right now, and you're going to see Tyler come down here, great tackle, but you know he's 8 yards down the field.
Ruiz will move to the right of quarterback Ricky Davis. Davis looks over to the sideline. Now we'll fake. Keep, and he is stopped after a short gain. Al-Rashid Benton, the linebacker, comes up to make the stop right at the line of scrimmage.
Nice tackle there. He just comes right off the block. And again, there's another defender there if he didn't make the tackle, but second and 10's a heck of a lot better for West Virginia defense than it is when it's second and 5, so just got to stop these holes from getting so big, and you can't have these running backs 5-6 yards down the field before they're being touched, so good play there.
Trips to the left. West Virginia showing pressure. They come with it. Davis throws, has time, and is complete. Boy, Ricky Davis, an excellent pocket, and he's able to throw it out there to Isaiah Scott. Another first down inside Mountaineer territory down to the 44-yard line.
It's that cover zero I talked about before. It's an all-out blitz. Davis does a great job standing in there because there's one extra guy coming in on that blitz, and it's one-on-one on the back end. So a great throw, great job by Davis. Good job by the receiver getting open.
15-yard pickup has the ball down to the 44 of the Mountaineers.
That's
a whistle,
it's a risky,
and a timeout.
Risky coverage, I mean, for Coach Gibson. It's got to, you cover zero. I mean, there's no help. He breaks one tackle. It's a touchdown. So that's, he has a lot of confidence in his defensive backs back there to call this this defense this many times already.
So this play is under review. Here's Scott going up for the ball.
It's a little loose at the end.
So you can see the signal by Jeremy Tyler. He thought it was incomplete. Well, you can see the nose of the football mark hitting the turf there.
Yeah.
Rasul Douglas in coverage.
Did move just a little bit. I know back when I was playing, we probably got away with those, but now with all the great camera angles and the guys in the truck, great job getting a shot of that. And right here at the end, I think you can see the ball moves a little bit, and I think he loses possession, but.
Well, we're 0 for 1. Right on the slide. Let's see if we can improve our average to 50%. And that would be a tough one to come back for Youngstown State. Boy, they do a nice job picking up the blitz. Davis, a very decisive throw. Hits his receiver right in the hands. Again, we mentioned a very inexperienced receiving crew, and they need some kind of threat on the outside. Certainly, again, just enough, Mark, to keep the pressure off that running game.
They are. With the early running by Davis, I think that brought the safeties down on the box a little more, and it's going to give them some opportunities. But you got to convert if you want those opportunities to come to you. So, because West Virginia's got to account for the running ability of Davis. And plays like this, if it's not overturned, are the kind of plays you need. But I'd be surprised if this one doesn't come back.
Well, it's interesting, too. You have the incompletion. If it is an incompletion, you have the penalty. Again, after a big gain, 15 yards. Youngstown State's they're doing a couple things here with a potential drop here and a penalty that you don't like to do when you're an underdog. But by and large, it's been a pretty impressive showing early for the Penguins.
It has been. Again, guys, great look with this. I do think you see the ball move right there. But the play is there for the future. I mean, Youngstown State coaching staff, they'll look at this and they'll go back to that play. Looks like the officials are walking back.
At the corner right here. It'll be third down and 10.
Eddie Shelton says after the review, incomplete pass. So instead of a nice 15-yard pickup down to the 44. It's going to be that third and 10 situation that Bo Pelini and his staff probably doesn't want to see his offense in.
Certainly, yeah, these third and longs are tough. Looks like West Virginia is going to be in a two-shell, and Davis has been doing a good job so far.
Three receivers split to the left, one to the top of your screen, and Ruiz will be in as a sidecar to the right of quarterback Ricky Davis on a third and 10. Davis looking, little screen set up, and incomplete. Boy, Alvin Bailey was hammered coming across the middle. It's incomplete, and Youngstown State looked like they had a first down deep inside West Virginia territory. Instead, now will be forced to punt it away.
Yeah, that was a cover two man look, which means man with two in the back, and well, hit him with the hind.
Mark Schuler getting set to boot it away. Gary Jennings back deep. Schuler's last one, a 60-yarder, and he lets go another rocket that lands in the West Virginia end zone, and so will be another touchback, another huge punt by Mark Schuler. So West Virginia will start at their 20, still scoreless in the first quarter. Part of a long coaching tradition. Excellent coaches in Youngstown State history. This is Crawford. Crawford tries to step out of a tackle. Can't do it. Nice open field stop by Jameel Smith.
Yeah, nice job by Smith there. He came down from the cover two position, and it's a 10-yard pursuit and nice open field tackle.
Crawford, the National Junior College Player of the Year a year ago. The Tigers really like his potential. Now up top, deep, but nobody home. Incomplete. And it'll bring up a third and long. And this is no surprise to Youngstown State. A lot of times, FCS teams are just looking to make a decent showing, but Youngstown State's in these games to win. They played Michigan State very tough in 2011. They won at Pitt 31-17 in 2012. After a lopsided loss to Michigan State, they led Illinois into the fourth quarter of that game. The Illini had to rally, and they had a chance to tie the game late against Pitt. So this has been an impressive Youngstown State team as Howard steps out of a would-be sack and completes to White. Big play there by Skyler Howard as Jameel Smith makes his stop. Boy, Howard escaping that sack, Mark, is able to keep this drive alive.
That's the kind of plays they've come accustomed to getting from Skyler, and just a great job getting rid of the ball there, and White coming back. So that's the kind of plays that can change a game, the momentum game.
Howard keeps, and Howard nowhere to go. Avery Moss drills him, maybe a half-yard pickup. And, you know, we're talking about those teams that Youngstown State has played, and Pitt the last couple years in Illinois. Those are bowl teams, Mark, not just run-of-the-mill teams that they were playing and beating on one occasion, as you see the tackle here by Moss.
Yeah, these are the kind of hits I think you wanted to avoid having Skyler take today, but I don't think anything else is there, so they're trying it. But like you said, Rob, you can see it's very evident, this team. They got some athletes. They're a big physical team.
Here's the give to Crawford. Crawford finds some room. Crawford off the right side and spun down again. Jameel Smith, another nice open field tackle, but a good pickup out to the 40 for Crawford.
Nice open field tackle by Smith. Yeah, he bounces it. As you can see, Youngstown State does have the speed to run them down. A lot of times athletes like that, Crawford can get outside and beat guys, but Youngstown State certainly has the speed to run them down.
Third and three. Crawford stays in the game. Wellman, the fullback, to the left of Skyler Howard. It's a snap. Gives to Crawford. Crawford will pick up first down yardage, leans forward out near the 45-yard line.
Nice run by Crawford, just north and south. Didn't go sideways, only needed the 3-4 yards for the first down, and it's the kind of runs that keep drives going and make coaches happy. Really nice cut there. Just head down, get the first down.
Jalen Kelly just from up the road in Washington, Pennsylvania, made that stop, went to Washington High School. Crawford four rushes now for 15 yards as they're taking a look at Savon Smith. A lot of WPIL players on both sides, as you can imagine, Mark. Coming down, of course, you were a WPIL player yourself, coming down here to West Virginia, and Youngstown being very close. They've got a number of players from Western Pennsylvania.
It's tough recruiting up here in Western Pennsylvania with, you know, Youngstown State, West Virginia, Pitt, Penn State, Ohio State. So it's if you score any of these guys, it's a It's a really good job by the recruiter. And Youngstown State, I mean, this isn't just the last three, 4 years. They've been from all the way back when, you know, they were winning national championships every year in the 90s under Tressel. This program's been good for a long, long time. This isn't just a new thing since Coach Pelini got here, but he's certainly keeping the tradition.
Bill Narduzzi, great success in the 70s and then in the 80s, and Jim Tressel really taking it to another level. As you mentioned, the four national championships throughout the 90s. Now Bo Pelini taking over, big name coach as well. First down at the 45. Give to Crawford. Crawford looking to get to the edge and spins off a couple tackles. Moss is able to make the stop.
And not a lot of room there. Again, you have to run these plays, though, to set up the long passes, because these safeties are starting to cheat down a little bit, and that's why they're stopping the run. But this will set up a shot, I believe, pretty soon.
Maybe this is that shot. Going to go deep down the right sideline for White, who makes the over-the-shoulder grab and gets into the end zone for the score.
I wasn't on the headset, but I saw it coming. You can't just take 2-3 yards so many times. They were definitely setting something up, and just a great play design, great throw, great catch by White.
53 yards from Howard to White.
Yeah, just the throw. You want to keep it on the outside shoulder. He's double covered, and he puts it in the best place you could possibly put it, right on the outside of the numbers. Starting to look a lot like his brother, isn't he?
Ke'Ron White, yeah, Kevin White, obviously, in the NFL, a first-round draft choice for the Bears. And Mike Molina on to try the extra point. And the kick is up, and it is good. 8-play, 80-yard drive for the Mountaineers, capped off on the 53-yard hookup from Skyler Howard to Ke'Ron White. First career touchdown for White as the Mountaineers up by the score of 7-0. Just hook up for the Mountaineers this year in week two. 53 yards from Howard to White. Here's the kickoff by Molina. It's going to be taken by Darian Townsend. Townsend at his 3 to the 15, trying to get to the edge. Now we'll cut back and find a little room. And he's slung out of bounds near the 30-yard line. As we take a look at this, Mark, you called the shot. What are you seeing here?
You're going to go with the play fake to try to get the safeties to come down. So the top safety does come down a little bit. And Jamil Smith down here, the safety, actually did a pretty good job of not freezing too bad. But Dwight just ran by, and that's just, you know, long strides, a perfect throw. And, you know, just an athlete on an athlete. So I honestly thought Jamil Smith didn't do too bad of a job, but he's got to get a little deeper. But that's why they've been cheating up, trying to stop the run.
And now Youngstown State will try to reestablish their offense. It's been pretty good. They made a couple of mistakes, a penalty and a drop pass on their first couple of drives. Davis. We'll give to Tevin McCaster, who's checked in. McCaster will cross the 30 out to the 31-yard line. McCaster from Newcastle, Pennsylvania. Adam Schuler, the fine-looking redshirt freshman, makes the stop for the Mountaineers.
Again, not bad. It's a positive play. Get yourself in a second and manageable situation. And they've been pretty effective today, getting themselves in third and shorts and getting first down. So, all in all, not a bad first down.
Two tight end look. Davis looks over. Now doesn't know what he wants to do here. He's able to hustle up to the line of scrimmage with just 3 on the play clock. And just does get it off. Now the option to McCaster. And McCaster out to the 35-yard line, flagged down behind the play. Xavier Preston on the stop.
Just an option read off the end, and Dave's did a great job pitching it out, but the pursuit, Coach Gibson's defense was there quick. So, but still, they're in the third manageable, 3rd and 3, 3rd and 4.
So the flag picked up, no call on the play, and it's going to be a 3rd and short. Davis back. Steps up, throws, intercepted. Picked off, there's a penalty flag down. Rasul Douglas on the return. Douglas down to the 28-yard line. Another flag comes flying in. So two flags right now. It's an interception by Rasul Douglas. But let's see if this is going to stand up.
I got a look here. Steps into it. Nice, nice step in. Just led him too far. I don't know if the defender hooked or if there was a little push before we could see it, but he's got to get the ball down. Again, that's that one-on-one coverage Coach Gibson's been going to a lot today, and I said a lot of responsibility on the defensive backs, but they've been up to the challenge so far.
Intended for DeMond Patterson. And so the penalty is going to be on West Virginia defensively. It's going to be an automatic first down for the Youngstown State Penguins.
And just when I say it, there's probably a reason why he threw it so high and in front of him. You know, you never know. He probably hooked them.
Defense number 13, 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Call is holding.
Sideline warning, West Virginia.
This is their first. Yeah, coming off the ball, just put his hands around his neck. And you work all week, and it's all timing. So when a defender puts his hands on you like that and breaks up the timing, the throws, they are going to be off. So I take that back.
It was a terrific catch by Douglas, wasn't it?
It was. Usually you put your worst guys with hands on defense, and that's why they're on defense. But I think he could probably play on the good guy's side.
That's the old expression, the best athletes on the field play cornerback, and if they could catch, they'd be playing wide receiver, right?
Exactly.
No disrespect meant. That's not an original statement. So a first down for the Penguins at the 45-yard line. Davis back, looking. And a throw, has a man out there. It's complete. And that is going to be enough for a first down as Robert Byrd makes the catch for Youngstown State.
Nice route. This was just a simple slant and go with a stop. So I don't know if that's built in. They can read that if the cornerback's over the top so much. But regardless, great throw and a nice route.
And what we expected, sort of max protect look, just one receiver out there making sure they can protect quarterback Ricky Davis, and he's able to hook up with that receiver for the first down.
Putting a lot of responsibilities on these DBs.
Hand off left side. This is McCaster, who will roll across the 30 down to the 28. Good gain on first down. He'll pick up 5 yards.
Seems like they've gone this play a ton already, and nice seal by the fullback and just bounced it for 5-6 yards. Take that all day. And
Kaiser White comes up to make the stop, but a nice gain on first down for Youngstown State. Again, deliberate to the line of scrimmage, in no hurry to get the ball snapped.
Yeah, I think that's an important point, Rob. He's been running the clock down inside five every time, and I think that's an effort to keep West Virginia off the field, obviously.
Davis gets the snap. Fire. And again, incomplete. And boy, he and Townsend didn't look like they were running the same play there. Townsend stopped up, Mark, it looked like, and Davis expected it looked like him to keep coming.
Yeah, Townsend, he looked like he wanted to, should have came a little flatter. That's the old quarterback in me saying that. But again, it's these one-on-one situations, and West Virginia's given a cushion. I wouldn't be surprised if there's just a simple 5-yard hitch or something just to get them back on the same page.
Throws have been there. Again, they do have an excellent kicker in Zach Kennedy. Davis looking over, trying to get the play call. Now 6 on the play clock, 5-4.
Here comes it.
And Youngstown State's going to have to use a timeout, and they do. Important play for them. They wanted to get the timeout called to make sure they get the right play called. And you hate to see, Mark, teams use timeouts that they don't have to, but you know, I've never liked the expression burn a timeout, because sometimes it's smarter just to regroup maybe and get the right play called and try to pick up a crucial first down here.
Sure. Just like you said, this is 3rd and 5. This isn't a 3rd and 13 where it's just going to be a screen or a draw. This is an important play. Yeah, I know they have a good kicker and they want to get 3 points, but you know, getting another first down here, you can't let West Virginia get up 14-0 in the first quarter. So I think it was a smart first down.
And other factors here, Kennedy normally kicks on turf. He does kick on grass, but the home field is turf. It's a big stadium, 45-yard attempt, certainly not a chip shot, although he does have the wind at his back right now. Here's a look at the series history. The only time they met was in the very first year of Youngstown State football, back in 1938, a 27-6 West Virginia victory. I'm not sure we can glean much from that.
Yeah, I don't know if the forward pass was invented yet.
But you and I were talking about that. It kind of surprising, Mark, that you would think they would have played more because of just the proximities of the schools over the years.
Sure. You know, and especially since the program Youngstown State has built, this isn't just a cakewalk every year. This would be good competition, so I hope they look into the future with this game.
So now the play has been called. Davis back in the shotgun with McCaster to his right. A look over again. Western Union is showing blitz. Here they come. Davis steps up, throws, and it is complete to Townsend. Spun down right at the first down marker. Looks like it's going to be just enough before Rasul Douglas was able to make the stop.
Coverage zero once again. Man to man. There's no help on the safety, so they have to give some cushion, and they hook up on this one. So look for them to run that play again, and the wheel route will be open next time.
And no pretense of even getting to the line of scrimmage. Youngstown State content to let the first quarter clock go down to zeros. So West Virginia on the long 53-yard touchdown pass from Skyler. There. Dan will also be along at halftime with Rasheed Marshall. First play of the second quarter. Youngstown State's been very impressive, very good-looking offense so far in this game and defense. Now Davis in trouble, going to flip one out to McCaster. McCaster has room, crosses the 10, and is dragged down by Harper as he gets inside the 10 and down to the 7-yard line.
Great play by Davis here. A couple of guys coming in unblocked. He just does a great job right there avoiding it. Just to get rid of the ball was a great play, let alone getting it in his running back's hands. It's the kind of plays he's going to have to make if they want to stay in this game, and so far I've been really impressed.
They've been good offensively, good defensively. They've been able to drive the ball. They've been their own worst enemy a couple of times on drives, but now threatening at the 7. First and goal. Davis will keep. Davis has room. Davis hurdles a man, blasted as he gets down to the 1-yard line. But a nice gain as Jeremy Tyler comes up to make the big hit.
Here comes Davis on the outside. I thought if he stayed outside, it was a touchdown, but bam, hit him with a hind. 1-yard line.
It did look like it was there to the corner, but Davis, showing no ill effects, bounces right up the ball at the 1. Second and goal. Give to Ruiz. Ruiz off the left side, spins, and Ruiz is in for the touchdown. An impressive drive by Youngstown State and a chance to tie with an extra point.
Yeah, we go back to that timeout they called on that crucial third down. How important was that now? But a great run here by Ruiz. Stopped at the 1 and just spins out. All he needed was a yard, so knew the situation. Yeah, nice penetration there by West Virginia, but just an even better run. But again, Rob, that timeout, I think that was such a good call back on that 3rd and 5.
Able to keep that drive alive. Now Zach Kennedy with a chance to tie it. Kick is up, and that kick by the all-conference kicker Zach Kennedy is good. So Youngstown State comes into Morgantown. They answer the Mountaineers' long touchdown run with a long touchdown drive capped off by the Ruiz 1-yard run to tie the game at 7.
Back to Morgantown, West Virginia, where Youngstown State and West Virginia are tied at 7. And if you follow country music, you are certainly familiar with Brad Paisley and his love of college football. The Glendale, West Virginia native held a free concert last night on the College of Law Hill as part of his Country Nation College tour. Despite early rain, thousands were in attendance to welcome him home. He wore his trademark number 15 West Virginia jersey, which signifies the year that the college tour began. Guys.
Meg, thanks very much. As Gary Jennings settles under the ball inside the 5. And Jennings will get out to the 23-yard line, which is where West Virginia will take over on offense following the 9-play, 72-yard drive by Youngstown State. Began in the first quarter, ended in the second, took up 4 minutes and 21 seconds, and resulted in a game-tying touchdown.
Not only that, more importantly, I think the time of possession here with the way Youngstown State's methodically going down the field and keeping West Virginia's offense on the sideline, that was the game plan. And I think they're going flawlessly right now with what the goal was coming into this game.
Russell Schell checks back in, the running back position. And they'll get the handoff off the right side. Armin Delevay chasing him down from behind will stop him, but not until Shell picks up five. Good blocking on the right side of that offensive line. Orlovsky, the center. You have Bosch, Lazard over there. Able to get a nice line surge and a pick up a five. Shell now empties the set. Howard looking, floats over the middle, complete to shorts, banged right at midfield, but hangs on and picks up the first down for the Mountaineers as Smith came over to make the stop.
Great throw by Howard, great catch by shorts. Right down the middle of the field, you'll see the cover two look. That's where the soft spot is, and great job holding on to the ball there.
22-yard pickup. Hand off to Shell. Shell straight up the middle.
Give us the Shell.
And West Virginia, want to keep this pace going. I know we mentioned the heat earlier. It's got to be 120, 130 down there, and you'll start to see some hands on hips, and West Virginia is certainly rested from that last drive. So
huddling up here. Sometimes you worry about getting too impatient and too fast, Mark, right? Because, boy, if you go three and out, and obviously they're not doing that here, that's the last thing you want to do. Here's the reverse. Durant, well defended, but he steps inside Delevate and is able to pick up a few. Looked like that might be a loss on the play, but Durant able to turn it into a short gain. Jamar Pinnock makes the stop.
Yeah, great run by Durant. You're looking for a home run, but, again, you don't want to start out, you know, third and 11 here. And he, to get 7 yards there is a heck of a job. And that's just the kind of athletes that the West Virginia likes to go and recruit that is tougher for some other smaller schools like Youngstown State to get. So good job just getting those 7 yards.
Third and three. Under center for a rare look from Skyler Howard. He'll give to Shell, and Shell's hit in the backfield. Shell is going to be stopped well short of the first down. Maybe picked up a yard. Boy, Jameel Smith in there again. He's been all over the field for Youngstown State. This is going to be a fourth down.
Yeah, they brought an extra defender off the slot. Seems like Jameel Smith came in just unblocked. I don't know if it missed assignment, but here we go. Go for it.
Cody Squirek on the stop. And now Youngstown State with Delevate hustling off the field. Not sure they had the right personnel out there. It's West Virginia lining up to go for it, so Bo Pelini will call a timeout.
Again, I think that's a good timeout. I know Coach Pelini's irate right now on the sidelines, and probably rightly so since the wrong personnel was in, but it's a big play.
So tied up at seven, fourth down for the 16th season, but they're lined up to go for one now. Skyler Howard comes in out of the timeout. Youngstown State set up defensively, and they will go with a spread look. They went with the eye on a third and three. Now fourth and two, they'll spread out Youngstown State. Shell the sidecar to the left. Howard's going to come up and change the play, and now we have a flag, and it's going to be thrown in the backfield. Let's see what the call is going to be.
I was saying right before the break that I thought that was a good timeout by Coach Pelini. At this point in the game, you don't want to have two in the first quarter, but too important of a play, I believe, to keep them in the game.
Take a look at both coaches now. An important call here. Let's see what it's going to be.
False start. Number seven of the offense. 5 yards.
That makes
so
the decision
false start.
Easy.
Wow. Now the punt team is being motioned out by head coach Dana Holgerson. I have to confess, I didn't see the movement. I think they called it on Russell Shell. Billy Kinney will be punting it away. Kinney's boot. Townsend will let it land. And batted back in play and downed at the 1 yard line. Nope, they're going to say now a touchback. So a late call on the touchback as we take a look at Youngstown State's defense, and they've done, Mark, a very, very good job.
They have. That's a good break there. That was a great play. And Coach Holgerson, he's on the field here. You better watch. Real nice open field tackling so far from Youngstown State. They're swarming to the ball, and They had the speed to match up. That was one thing I was worried about. I didn't think the speed would match up with West Virginia coming in, but I've been really impressed with how fast laterally they are.
Well, West Virginia is going to come up, and if they count X amount of players in the box, they're going to run the football, and we're seeing a lot of 4-1, 4-2 looks. West Virginia should be able to run the ball, Mark, against that look, shouldn't they?
You should. I mean, when you see the two-shell look, you run the ball, and you see one high, you throw it. And been in these big holes for Youngstown State.
Here's the handoff. Inside, it's McCaster, who will slither out close to the 25-yard line. Looks like they're going to mark him down across the 24, four-yard gain before Al-Rashid Benton can make the stop. And again, as you pointed out, 4 yards, they're delighted with that on first down.
Sure, when you have the single high, like I just mentioned, they have an extra guy down there. The safety comes down, and if you're not making the tackle after 4 yards, it's second and six. Youngstown State will take that all day.
Davis. Give to McCaster, this time just a short gain over the 25 to the 26.
Another third and medium range here. They've been pretty good so far today executing these, and this is when the pressure's been coming. So curious to see if West Virginia will bring that pressure or maybe fake the pressure and try to bait him into a bad throw.
That was Howard on the stop. He'll stay in the nickel look. Isaiah White showing blitz off the edge. Here he comes. Davis back. Lofts. Has a man downfield. And it's going to be complete. And now running away with it is Alvin Bailey. Alvin Bailey inside the 10 and into the end zone for Youngstown State.
That's that wheel route I was a little bit afraid about with that cover zero. There's no help. You break one tackle and it's going to be a touchdown. And they've been hitting that slant all game. So look at the underneath slant. And then there's the wheel route. So that was set up from earlier completions on the slant. But when you have 101, it's really, really a lot of pressure on that DB, because if he doesn't make the tackle, they hit their head on the goalpost, and that's just what happened. And
74 yards floated out there by Davis Bailey. The grab breaks one tackle, and he's gone, and Youngstown State has the lead.
Great throw, too. Well, Davis gave him a chance on those. You just don't want to overthrow them. Then the receiver has no chance, but when it's 101, you give your receiver a chance and good things can happen just like that.
Youngstown State's been methodical, and now they go to the big play. A FCS upsets over FBS schools. We mentioned Youngstown State already. They defeated Pitt back in 2012. Appalachian State in one of the more noteworthy upsets at Michigan, 34-32. The James Madison Dukes over Virginia. You saw the rest of the list there as well. And Youngstown State, and this has not been flukish, a career-long touchdown pass for Davis, but other than that, Mark, they've been able to come in, execute their game plan offensively and defensively.
Sure, I mean, other than the one turnover, that's, like you said, it hasn't been flukish. This is just executing the game plan, and I think we got a hold here, so going to have bad field position to start.
And Gibson was trapped inside his own 20-yard line. The flag, again, back around the 30-yard line. The officials will confer. We'll get the call. Preliminarily says against West Virginia.
During the return, holding.
So it is a hold.
The return team.
After the distance from the 18, should be back inside the 10-yard line. And Mark, you successfully called West Virginia's shot down the field, and you successfully called that wheel route by Youngstown State. Really set up, by the run and again by a lot of the shorter throws they've been completing?
It is. Those slants, they pay off. And when you're not taking shots, I know the coaches up here in the booth saw what I saw on the slant earlier in the game. The wheel came wide open, and I knew they'd eventually go back to it. And you got to be patient as a coach to pick your spots, and that's the hardest thing to do. But they were patient and found a great opportunity in the right spot of the field to do it.
Howard, handoff. Ooh, wow. Crawford is dropped in his tracks by Avery Moss.
This looks just like a missed assignment. I don't know, he had the assignment right, just got beat. And that's the kind of hits as a back you hate to take, because you expect to have a hat on a hat, and they hurt.
Very talented pair of defensive ends. Now Howard will step up, he'll throw, but good coverage downfield. Incomplete, intended for White. It will be third and long. And some buzzing and some booing here at Milan Pushkar Stadium. Some unsettled fans here, Mark.
Yeah, I mean, he's got to watch himself a little bit with that one, being backed up like this. You don't want to give him the ball at midfield. So I think he'll take that incompletions, but there was two safeties there. You don't want to make a big mistake, but the momentum definitely has shifted to the Penguin side.
Four receiver set on third and 10. Now empty. Howard back, pressure in his face, able to complete, and Shorts, Dekeel Shorts. Boy, what a great rapport Howard and Shorts have. First down, they move the sticks just across the 20-yard line.
Yeah, nice route by Shorts. He comes across the field on a drag and fakes it and comes back out of it. We used to call that a hairpin, and Tyler made a great throw. Put it right on the outside shoulder, and it's a good confidence builder. He got them out of that bad field position, too.
Off the left side. Again, not much there. Avery Moss able to make the stop.
Well, once again, you gotta run these plays to set up other ones. If you don't hand the ball off every once in a while and take those two-yard gains, you're not going to get the shots. You got to be disciplined and stick with your plan, and Coach Holgerson is so far. I mean, sure, he has some more shots up his sleeve, though.
Howard back, looking, now moves to his left. He's going to tuck it and go, looking for the first down stick. It's going to be very close, out across the 30. Looks like he's got enough near the 32.
Yeah, nice job by Howard not to force it there. That was cover two. The middle field's wide open, but none of the routes were headed in there. And that's just demoralizing. You have a coverage, and you hope for a coverage sack, and then for Skyler to come out and pick up the first down with his feet, really it's demoralizing, like I said, for the defense. And I'm starting to see a couple hands on hips of defenders with this heat.
Big look with two tight ends in the backfield. Give to Crawford off the right side. He'll bang over the 35 out to the 36. A four-yard gain on first down. Jamar Pinnock with the stop.
Just like we've been saying for Youngstown State, it's a good first down. Second and six, you have plenty of options now.
Same look. Howard takes a knee. Communicate with center Orlovsky. Take to Crawford. Howard in trouble. Ball up in the air, batted around, and incomplete. Crawford picked it up just in case it was a lateral, but the officials call it incomplete. Good pressure up the middle on the play-action pass.
That was one we just talked about. They were going to take a shot at the top of the field here. It was one-on-one. It was pretty good coverage up top, but I think he was just going to give
Rivers
a chance there. Yeah. I'm not sure if that was backwards or...
Rivers, a school record, 27 sacks.
Fortunate to have that an incomplete pass there. Still manageable, third and six or so.
Howard back. Throws out in the flat to Crawford and forgot the ball. Incomplete, looking to make a move upfield. And it'll be another punting situation for the Mountaineers.
Man, we all know what happened there. There's no reason to beat up on Crawford. It's just, you know, he turned his head to make a play before he caught the ball, and the defender's on his way, so you can understand he was going to have to make someone miss to get that first down.
Back for Youngstown State, Darian Townsend.
Townsend back deep. Kenny to punt it away for West Virginia. Oh, he hammers one. Townsend back inside his 10. Makes one man miss. Now has a seam. Crosses the 20. The 25 spins out to the 28-yard line before Wellman can make the stop. Good return by Darian Townsend. So Youngstown. Motion at the top of your screen. Fake to Ruiz. Davis rolls out. Will go into the flat. Complete to his tight end Shane Kuhn. And Kuhn will get out to about the 33-yard line. So good gain on first down. Nice safe play, Mark, and they pick up six.
That's been their game plan all day. I think it's been it's one of those deals you talk about in the coach's room, and you want to get first downs, and keep West Virginia off the field, and it's gone really well so far.
Fake to Ruiz. Davis will keep, and Davis... knocked down as he gets across the 35. Rasul Douglas into the stop.
Just that read option they've been running all game, and they're getting third and one. And Rob, I think it's just these manageable situations they've been able to convert has really been the key today for them to move these chains and hold the ball so long. They, they're not in third and long often. It just seems like every time it's third and one, third and two, or third and five.
And they are 3 for 3 on third down. Davis comes to the line of scrimmage. Once again, deliberately paced. 3 on the play clock. Give off the left side. Ruiz is hit in the hole. And the whistle blows. And they're going to stop him back at the 36. So, again, trying to protect players. A little quicker whistle than maybe we've seen in the past. And Ruiz stopped in the hole. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, West Virginia had all 11 up. Just great penetration and swarming to the ball.
By the way, I said 3 for 3 on third down. There were 3 for 5, now 3 for 6 on third down as Mark Schuler gets set to punt it away to Shelton Gibson.
Schuler in punt formation for LSU.
Every time they've punted it, he's done such a great job punting it. It hasn't hurt them too bad.
It's actually Jennings back deep. Low liner. Jennings wants to stay away from the ball. And it will take a Youngstown State bounce inside the 15 down to the 14. So West Virginia is able to come up with a stop there. Halftime report is coming up. Dan Potash and Rasheed Marshall, another player from Pittsburgh who came down here to Morgantown and had a very successful career as a quarterback for the Mountaineers. They'll have first half analysis. Big 12 action. We can tell you that Central Michigan, last we saw, leading Oklahoma State in that game, 22-ranked Oklahoma State. So a lot of action going on, and West Virginia not the only Big 12 team with their hands full this afternoon. Off the left side, it's Shell, and again, give credit to Rivers and Squirick and Smith and Moss, those guys up front for Youngstown State have been very stout.
They have been. There's just been no chunk plays. You want to get chunk plays with these runs every once in a while, but they've done a good job avoiding those. You know, when I go back to Skyler, you don't know these ribs, how much they could be bothered him. And, you know, watching games, I see him run a lot more. And today it just seems like he's given the ball more than that read. And it could be a rib issue.
Squirek to stop from Indiana, PA. Mentioned Western Pennsylvania players here. Pass out in the flat. This is Shell. Shell looking for some room. Shell ducks under one man, keeps the legs moving. Jalen Kelly makes the stop out at the 21.
Yeah, on this little bubble screen, I mean, it looks simple, but the quarterback's got a really tough throw there. And, you know, you put it right on the numbers, the perfect spot on the upfield shoulder. And again, this Youngstown State, they swarm. It seems like there's a lot of white jerseys.
Howard throws, intended for Gibson. And it looks like it's going to be a pass interference call as Kenny Bishop was hanging on Gibson's back. And it is going to be pass interference, and so a first down for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about that call. We're not too close to the field, but we could see that from here. Actually worried me a little bit.
Pass interference. Number 7 of the defense. Ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Yeah, I was just saying, I actually thought he was going to undercut it and maybe intercept it, but the reason he was undercutting it was pretty much climbing up his back. He's got a handful of jersey there. And
by the way, Adam Pankey checking in for his first action at left guard. Was ineligible last week, longtime starter for the Mountaineers. So see if that makes a difference on those runs inside. And trouble for Howard as Howard gets over in a late little push, little help out of bounds from Armin Delevate, a longtime starter at West Allegheny High School, part of the powerhouse program assembled by Bob Palko. And again, not much room here for Howard to go.
No, it's a two-shell again. They had safeties over the top, and they were trying to take a shot. And speaking of shots, I think it could have easily been 15 right there.
And Delevate, a little help for Skyler Howard. Second and 9. Here's Shell. Shell lowers his shoulder, runs through a tackle, stretches out near first down yardage. Going to be about a half yard short, but Shell, a good, strong, physical run.
That's what you said. The safety came down, was there to make the play, and just pretty much runs right through him. I mean, that's just that's a tough guy to bring down.
And Shell hitting the hole, and will have enough for the first down. Crosses the 45. Tough yardage being picked up for Shell on his ninth carry of the game. Shell will take a breather, and Justin Crawford checks in. Howard back, looking, going to float one deep. Has a man down there. It's Gibson, hits him in stride, and Gibson into the end zone for the touchdown. 54 yards for the Mountaineers.
Once again, they're going to have these shots. You have those 2 and 3 yard runs, and you wonder why they keep doing it. You heard the fans booing a little bit, but it sets these up, these shots. And again, just another great deep ball by Skyler. He's been throwing the ball deep well today. Again, the play action faked. It looks just like the runs they've been running all day. And again, he just ran by, and the safeties where the corner was there, and the safety should have been over the top. But just watch this ball where it lands. You couldn't ask for a better spot as a receiver. And just a great route by Gibson, and his speed, I think you could see it right there.
Molina now on for the extra point. It is up, it is good, and it is tied with 3:15 remaining here in the first half. 6 plays, 86 yards, 54 yards for the score.
So right there, just that little fake. You never know. It just holds the safety just for that half a second, and that's all it takes when you have a guy as fast as Gibson. The safeties, they don't have to run up to 5 yards from the line. Just the fact that they didn't get back to their position is just enough when he's put that ball in his belly.
Gibson averaging 21 yards per catch over the course of his career, has been a big playmaker for the Mountaineers, and Dana Holgorsen has to be happy with that. 54 yards from his quarterback, Howard, to his big playmaking receiver, Gibson, and we are tied at 14 with 3:15 remaining here in the first half.
Mike Molina kicking off for the Mountaineers. Back for Youngstown State, number 21, Darian Thompson.
And number 5.
Kick is deep, and it will be taken by Townsend 8 yards deep in the end zone, and he will take a knee there.
I think this is an important drive for Youngstown State, just to keep the chains moving, at least get a couple first downs, and don't let the field position get out of hand right here, because if they go 3 and out and West Virginia gets the ball back, and the momentum can switch and really, really fast. So I think it's key if they can get at least 1 or 2 first downs right here.
I don't know if coaches think about this or players think about this, but I know fans start thinking about, well, who gets the ball first in the second half? That would be Youngstown State. So from their perspective, if you can keep this thing tied going into halftime, get the ball first in the second half, feel like you can get some momentum going after the break.
So you get 1 or 2 first downs, then you're thinking, okay, let's go score. But again, no negative plays. Don't get in third and long.
Give to Ruiz. Ruiz off the right side is hit. Jared Harper and Noble Wachuku on the stop defensively for the Mountaineers.
Safeties are coming down again. You know, it's just a matter of West Virginia starts using timeouts, if they can get a good stop here and put them in that third and long.
Mountaineers do have 3 timeouts left, and Youngstown State looked like they wanted to snap the ball quickly. You would think that clock is something they'd be keeping an eye on. Now we're down at 10 seconds on the play clock. Davis back, looking, throws over the middle, has Kuhn, his tight end. And Kuhn will wrestle forward and stretch out across the 35 to the 36. It's a first down before Justin Arndt can make the stop.
It's a great job. You know, like I said, you just want to get 1 or 2 first downs before this half ends. And great sit-down route. Read the route perfect and got his first down, and now Youngstown State will just take their time and get 3 great, but just don't want to give West Virginia a chance to get back on the field.
Mountaineers do have all 3 timeouts remaining. 2 left, or 1 left, I beg your pardon, for Youngstown State. They've used 2. Davis looking, throwing, and too tall for Raider, his intended receiver out in the flat. Mentioned the Western Pennsylvania players. He's from Pine Richland High School.
It's one of those ones that looks like a terrible throw to tie, but when you're throwing it that late to the flat, it's better to be safe than sorry. And he was throwing it all the way across the field, and I think just not throwing to the flat late is one of the rules you're taught early on as a quarterback.
And we used to see a lot more of those when they had the big crown in the field here in West Virginia.
You certainly did. It looks a lot better now being level.
Snap over the head of Davis. Davis able to pick it up. Davis trying to get to the edge. He's going to get there. Now makes another man miss. It gets close to the original line of scrimmage. Stays in bounds as well. Clock continuing to move. But wow, that was nearly disastrous for the Penguins.
Just a great play by Davis to get that ball back. You know, he had no chance of catching that. Just to, you know, when things are going good, they're going good. And going well, he got a fortunate bounce there. And like you said, that could have changed his game in a hurry.
Sean Walters and Christian Brown on the stop. Under a minute 20 left. Third and 13. Five on the play clock. Davis milking every moment of it. Now back. Design quarterback draw in trouble. He was bottled up by Schuler and brought down by Brown. And now West Virginia wants a timeout with 1 minute remaining here in the second quarter of play.
Yeah, I didn't suspect anything crazy out of them on that long third down. That's what I've been saying. You don't want to be in the third and long situation. But hey, they got a first down. They ran a good portion of the clock off. If West Virginia goes down in 1 minute and scores, good for them. But I think the offense at Youngstown State did their job there. Minus the, you know, the bad snap, which, you know, that's not really on any of your skill guys.
And that, again, is the kind of thing we talked about this. So, Mark, you know, a drop pass early on a reviewed play. Prior to that, there was an unsportsmanlike, a late hit charged against Youngstown State. You'd think those sort of penalties, those sort of mistakes would be crippling. Youngstown State's found a way to overcome them all. They're going to try to overcome that high snap here now with a minute remaining in the second quarter. Mark Schuler, Rugger-style kick. And it does not take a good roll for Youngstown State. Will be down at the 35-yard line with 51 seconds remaining for West Virginia.
Yeah, West Virginia brought the house there. I think they brought 10 guys rushing the punter there. And those first few punts were really boom. But he did a good job just getting that punt off. That was his number one goal there, just get the punt off with West Virginia coming to block it there.
Well, we've talked about Youngstown State's perspective, trying to keep that momentum going into halftime. And now West Virginia, from their perspective, obviously a chance here to take the lead. Shell empties out the look. Howard back in trouble, being chased, going to throw and wisely throwing over the head. He talked about those late throws in the flat over the head of Shell with Rivers closing, David Rivers closing very quickly.
Well, there's all kinds of rules for coaches. There's no late throws in the flat. There's no late throws across your body. There's no late throws down the middle. So it's pretty much if you throw it late, throw it safe, because there's no good place late to throw the ball unless you're going to your check down.
Again, mentioned David Rivers, the cornerback. Derek Rivers, the fine defensive end for Youngstown State. Howard back, looking, throwing, and nearly intercepted. That was Leroy Alexander. Who came up, I beg your pardon, Kenny Bishop, who came up to make the pass break up.
He really sat on that. He got a good jump and great play. He's got to watch himself doing that, though. That ball gets through. That could be six points in a hurry, especially this late in the half. You don't want to do anything too risky as a corner.
41 seconds remaining, third and 10. West Virginia, 4 of 7 on third down. Howard back, looking, throwing over the middle, complete. And inside Penguins territory with the reception is Dekeel Shorts as Leroy Alexander makes the stop. Now nears quickly to the line of scrimmage.
Cover two, that's where the soft spot is, right in the middle of the field. Move that Mike linebacker and there's a huge, huge hole.
Clock moving, Howard back, looking, stepping up, doesn't see anybody. Now rolling out to his right, will throw and will complete. And it's Shorts again down to the 30-yard line with 20 seconds remaining here in this first half.
Great job by Howard extending the play here. There was really no one open. He just bought about 4 or 5 extra seconds, and great job by Shorts coming back to the ball.
And we have a whistle, stop and play, and Bo Pelini elects to use his final timeout of this first half. Again, Josh Lambert, the Mountaineers' longtime and highly successful kicker, unavailable for the first three games of the season. Mike Molina stepped in from Hurricane West Virginia, was 4-for-4 in his field goal attempts in week one against Missouri. Sure, Dana Holgorsen is thinking touchdown first, but you'd at least like to take the lead here.
You would. You'd suspect Youngstown State is going to stay in their cover two shell. So if anything happens, it's going to be in the middle of the field. The corners will be protected if they stay in the two, and that's what I would suspect. So, you know, Youngstown State probably just wants to hold them to field goal. And with West Virginia, with the two timeouts, they could still even run the ball.
There's Mike Molina, the redshirt junior. Skyler Howard has thrown for 216 first half yards, a couple long touchdown passes, has thrown one interception. Now trying to lead the Mountaineers to one more score before the break. You see his numbers there. First and 10 at the 31-yard line. If they go no further, it'd be a 48-yard attempt for Molina. Youngstown State showing some pressure. Now Rivers jumps off sides. They'll throw it out in the flat to Gibson. Gibson to the 25-yard line, stutter steps, and now he's going to be whistled down at the 19-yard line. Thompson with the stop flag back at the 31. You have to think that's where Rivers jumped off sides.
Yeah, that
off sides. Number 11 of the defense lined up in the neutral zone. That penalty was declined. The result of the play, first down.
That's a shame. They had the bubble screen on there because, as a quarterback, I used to love knowing when they're offsides because you knew there was a guy for a shot and you could throw it, not worry about the interception. And unfortunately, they had a screen on.
Here's Kennedy McCoy, the freshman, and McCoy will get down to the 12-yard line, 5 seconds remaining, and the Mountaineers are able to use their second timeout to set up the field goal attempt for Mike Molina.
8-6.
West Virginia leading the second.
You know, good job by West Virginia. It's coming down and getting points. You know, they gave up the one first down to Youngstown State right here. But they, you know, getting the ball and a big pass down the middle and Skyler buying time. So I wouldn't be too upset if I'm Coach Holgorsen getting this 3 points right here before the half. I mean, it's been a tough half if you're thinking about, you know, West Virginia was going to blow them out. So getting the lead is positive.
Been a good game for sure. Now back to action. Here's Molina lining things up. It'll be a 30-yard field goal attempt. Give the Mountaineers a lead. Boot by Molina is up, and the boot is no good. Wide left on the final play of the first half, so the Mountaineers don't grab that lead in the momentum going into the halftime break. Instead, it is 14-14. The Penguins have come in to Milan Pushkar Stadium and played West Virginia tough. That is not a fluky score. There's nothing strange that happened, just good football by Youngstown State. And a tie 14-14 going into the break. So we head downstairs where Meg Bulger is being joined by Dana Holgorsen.
Thanks, Rob. Coach, able to come up with some big plays defensively late in the second. What adjustments, if any, do you need to make defensively?
Well, we're not doing very good on third down. You know, it's not as good as that we've been. But, you know, we're not surprised that this is a close game. Youngstown's a good team. They were going to shorten it. They were going to make a few plays. We just don't need to panic, regroup, and come out and play the second half.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second. Rob?
Meg, thanks very much. 9-win team a year ago.
And I think they're proving that today. Their team speed is a lot better than I thought it would be. And so they just keep doing what they're doing, and they got a good game plan. Stick with it.
Molina through the end zone, so the ball will be spotted at the 25-yard line. That is where the Penguins will take over. Molina getting some congratulations, and now Youngstown State going to see if they can keep up what they were able to do in the first half. Good mix of pass and run. Able to drain a lot of clock, able to move the ball. Again, they had some other drives that were stalled by some of their own mistakes. A 15-yard penalty on a late hit, a drop pass on what would have been a first down in West Virginia territory. So the Penguins, they haven't even played perfect football. And here they are tied up 14-14 at the half.
Keep getting these first downs and moving those chains, keep that clock rolling.
First play of the second half now. Davis will throw and complete or incomplete. They're going to say incomplete, intended for Scott with Crawford in coverage.
Putting the ball right in the belly of the back and back to that slant with one-on-one coverage. And, the defender was right there on his back, so that was a good defensive play with tough catch.
Youngstown State replacing virtually all of their wide receivers from a year ago. They had a lot of speed outside, not as much speed this year, still an unproven core of receivers. Second and 10. And the keep, and nowhere to go for Davis. In fact, he's dropped for a yard loss. Christian Brown and Sean Walters in defensively for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, just a nice play. They got burnt with that earlier in the game in the first quarter. And, Davis was making a living doing that. And so Coach Gibson did a good job. They made some adjustments. And, again, situation third and long. This is not ideal for Youngstown State.
They've been going with maximum protection looks for the most part, but now spreading things out with four receivers. West Virginia showing blitz. Now backing off. Three men come. Davis back over the middle. Complete. First down. And across the 45 out to the 46 is Isaiah Scott for that first down for the Penguins.
Really nice route by Scott. That was the cover zero they were running a lot in the first half. And this time they fake it. So Davis does a great job going through his progression. Nice route. Perfect throw.
21-yard pickup for Scott, the 6'3", 205-pounder from Hubbard, Ohio. This is Tevin McCaster. McCaster off the left side. Wachuku hits him after a 2-yard gain.
Just impressed with the demeanor of the Youngstown State team. They, anytime they have a little bit of a hiccup or a penalty or anything, they seem to come right back at it and have a short-term memory. So it's impressive for a team coming into a tough environment like this, and they're up to the challenge.
Davis surveying the field. Two tight ends, two receivers split to his right. Get the snap on the option. Pitch out. Flag coming in behind the play as Ruiz gets across midfield down to the 47. Let's see what the flag is going to be.
Came from way in the back. I'm not sure. I saw a cut block on the slot receiver. I don't think that was the call.
There is no foul on the play. Third down.
They ran the option. The slot receiver put a heck of a cut block on the defender. And
so third and three now, Mark, is again, you talk about getting into those manageable situations. They just completed or converted the third and 10. They don't want to do that too often now. Third and three.
No, they've seemed to have gone the slant route a lot on these third and three situations. And let's see if Coach Gibson's going to bring the house again.
Mountaineers do bring pressure. Lofted. Receiver out there, but good coverage. Maurice Fleming running stride for stride. That was intended for Stefan Derrick. It's incomplete, and you would think here for Youngstown State punting situation, they will bring the punt team out.
Yeah, like you said, really good coverage by Fleming. That was back to that man-to-man coverage, and you know what? I know they're punting, but I like the aggressive call. It was the one-on-one situation and just a little overthrown, and that's, I mentioned the first half, that's what you want to do. You want to give your receiver a chance, so I think Davis would like to have that one back, but I like the aggressive play call there.
Sure to punt. Gary Jennings back for West Virginia. Schuler, a low liner, caught by Jennings, hit right in his tracks and dropped at the 16-yard line. That is where West Virginia will have the ball. Their opening possession of the second half, tied at 14 in Morgantown. Get the stop. They will take over at their own 14-yard line. Russell Schell behind quarterback Skyler Howard. To give to Schell off the right side. Schell finds a crease. Schell bangs forward out to the 25-yard line, and it looks like enough for a first down.
Great run there by Schell. He's running with a mission today. Just like how at the end of this run, how he finishes. The safeties don't want to come up and tackle him if he keeps finishing like that.
Schell 5'10", 220-pounder. Flag on the play. Crossing pattern is complete, enough for a first down pending the penalty as Tequila Shorts is brought down by Eric Thompson. Let's see what the call is going to be.
Nice throw there by Skyler.
Illegal formation. 5 men in the backfield offense. 5 yard penalty. Replay first down.
That's one of those penalties that drive you nuts. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. It really has no bearing on the play, but.
Do they have Lazard as being lined up in the backfield? Was that the call there, the right tackle? Either way, fourth penalty for 29 yards for the Mountaineers.
That's drive coaches nuts with those kind of penalties.
So it'll be a first and 15. Howard comes up, will change the play at the line. Give to Shell. Shell bounces to the outside. And Shell will get out over the 25 to the 27-yard line, a pickup of 7 yards for Derek Rivers. Closing for the backside makes a stop. There's Derek Rivers. 24 sacks in his last 24 games. Now going deep for Shelton Gibson in stride. Beautiful throw and catch as Shelton Gibson down to the 29-yard line of Youngstown State.
Another beautiful throw by Skyler Howard on one of these deep balls. He's been really accurate with his deep ball today.
55 yards right in the breadbasket.
Gibson's speed is, once he gets going.
There's Shell cutting back. He gets down to the 25-yard line to pick up a 4 on first down.
That's where Shell, I think, is most effective. You keep him between the tackles running north and south, and he gets that 4 and 5 every time.
Delevate on the stop. Give to Shell again. Shell picking his way forward, now spinning. Stays on his feet, wrestled down by Delevate once again. Looked like there was nothing there, but he'll get 4.
Yeah, he can pick his way through, and he's just a tough guy to bring down.
Now we have an official's timeout as a player is down for Youngstown State. And it looks like that is Eric Thompson. ...14-14, 10:47 remaining here in the third quarter at Milan Pushkar Stadium. West Virginia looking to be a team avoiding a rash of upsets that is spreading through college football.
Down here on the 22, I know Coach Holgerson, he wants to get to 7 here. The last week, I know he has to deal with the questions, the red zone questions, and they get old. And you work on it, and you work on it, and you work on it, and it just makes things worse sometimes because you press it. But 3rd and 2 is good. Get a first down and put the ball in the end zone. And this is back to the style of play they want to have.
You sometimes find that's play calling. Is it execution by the team? Is it just one of those things that happens in the red zone?
It's one of those things. You know, you work on something all week, and then they use a different coverage or it's execution, or and once you get in that rut, it just seems like it never ends because that's all the questions you get.
Crawford has checked in for Shell. He's behind Howard. Now Howard with Youngstown State showing blitz. Will scoot up under center. How about that? That's what he normally does when he comes up to mark to change the play. Instead, he stays under center, gets the ball, runs the quarterback sneak, and picks up the first down.
Yeah, well designed. He usually does come up and give signals to the outside so no one can pick him up. And might have caught Youngstown State's D-line a little bit off guard.
Yeah, he did. You can see guys with knees on the ground, and other players were looking over to get a call to see if they wanted to change their defense. So good, quick play as West Virginia picks up the first down. High formation. Fake. The throw. And nearly intercepted. Wow, does Jameel Smith wish he had that one back? He read it all the way, jumped right into the route, and couldn't hang on.
Yeah, he does a good job. He stayed right on the hash. I think Skyler just stays on him a little bit too long. J.C. Smith there, he just stayed right on the hash. And that could have actually went the other way for 7. So a good break for West Virginia, but you know, Youngstown State had their share too.
Now a power look. Two tight ends. Give to Crawford. Crawford bounces it outside to the 15. And slithers down to the 11-yard line. Picks up 6, maybe 7 yards on that run before Jameel Smith makes the stop.
Crawford, he probably wants his back. Like, he could have had a touchdown there. He slipped on the hash mark there, and that slowed him up just enough for that team to, for Youngstown State to come in and tackle him. But that's why you pursue. You do those drills, and good job by them to pounce on him.
Third and three. Same power look. They'll throw. Fade. End zone. Shorts with the grab, and Shorts is in for the score. Flag on the play. It won't matter as DeKeel Shorts, a terrific grab in the corner of the end zone, and the Mountaineers have retaken the lead.
Just a simple fade pattern here. You work on it, you work on it. It usually doesn't look that pretty.
Number seven of the
Skyler's told to throw it back to the back hash mark. Gets interfered with, but the ball is so perfect. Put it right on the money.
Your Youngstown State, you might want to take a look at this. Does he have that left foot in bounds? Very, very close. And they're out on the field yelling. They want the attention of the officials. They want this checked upstairs.
So even if they do not get a touchdown here, this will be a first down. But let's see if that right foot comes down first.
Well, to me, that's foot on the line. Now, we don't have a definitive angle there. Maybe you could say we're extrapolating that his foot would be on the line.
We're 1-1 today, so we have to, we got to be right to get above 500 here.
Just a tremendous catch. Great concentration by DeKeel Shorts. Again, there was a flag on the play. So we'll see if this 11-yard touchdown will stand or whether it'll be a penalty and a first down and goal to go for the Mountaineers.
I don't know. What do you think we go with, Rob? I think there's not enough to overturn it.
I'm going to disagree with you. I think it is going to be overturned. So one of us will be above the Mendoza line. Oh, boy, that's the angle you want to see, but the pylon looks like it's in the way.
It was.
That is just a great catch by DeKeel Shorts. He's become such a terrific receiver. He and Skyler Howard, again, have really developed a great rapport. Wow, we can't tell, can we? We can't tell.
Well, like I said, regardless, it will be a first down because of the pass interference. But if you're West Virginia, and as
after further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
But that's a relief. You're in the end zone and get that 7-point lead, and you erase that missed field goal before the half.
One of us is 2 for 3 on calls. It's the same one that has 2 Pro Bowls on his resume. Would not be me. As Molina on to try the extra point. Kick is up, and the kick is drilled through by Molina, and the Mountaineers, for the first time since they led 7-0, have the lead again. 21-14, 11-yard touchdown pass from Skyler Howard to DeKeel Shorts. Great catch for the Mountaineers, who have the lead for the first time since going up 7-0 on the Coran White 53-yarder from Skyler Howard. Short kick, going to be taken by Townsend. Townsend at the 6, crosses the 25, crosses the 30. Townsend across the 40-yard line before he's wrestled down by Antonio Crawford at the 45.
Townsend on the return for the Penguins.
Well, Milan Puskar Stadium undergoing a $50 million renovation, upgrades to the facility, and those efforts being spearheaded by Shane Lyons, the athletics director, who joins us now. And Shane, first of all, thanks very much for coming on. And secondly, if you could tell us a little bit about these renovations to the stadium.
Well, we spent a lot of time and effort in Rob, to try to make it more fan-friendly, wider concourse, more restrooms, more points of sale and concession stands. And I think we achieved that. Last week we had a great crowd here, had a few hiccups along the way, but today I hear things are going very well.
Great to hear. And I know the Aquatic Center also, and the Basketball Center, a lot of a lot of upgrades going on here.
Yeah, we have a lot of projects underway. Coliseum, it's a 46-year-old building that we've started ripping and tearing in this fall and trying to put it together for this fall. And that's going along very well. We have the Aquatic Center that's about ready to kick off at Milan Park, which will be an aquatics as well as a track facility, which we're long overdue with that as well. So a lot of great things from facilities are happening here in Morgantown.
And one of the things I know you've been concentrating on is student-athlete welfare.
You know, there's no question about it. I mean, that's why I got in the business, is for the student-athletes. And, you know, we can't lose focus. And one of the things when I started here, I talked to the staff of the department. I said, you know, what's our purpose and why are we here? And the fans are very important, but really our customers are our student-athletes. And, you know, one of the proudest days that I have as an athletic director is when those student-athletes walk across the stage and get their diplomas. And we want to make this an enjoyable experience for them and something they can look back in 4 or 5 years and say, that was the best time of my life.
Well, I think you're doing a great job. You know, my sisters and I, we both went here, and you know, these upgrades to the facilities, you know, the baseball, the basketball, the football, the aquatic center, this is just, I wouldn't recognize it 20 years ago. So you're doing a great job here. We've loved coming here.
Thank you, Mark. And it's, you know, obviously people like you that help lay the foundation to be able to do what we're doing today. And, you know, we're looking out for the best interests of all the fans and student athletes.
Option run keeper as Davis picks up 8 yards on that first down run. Let's take a look at the replay here. Novo Wachuku on the stop, but Davis's option in this keep. We saw it successful early, Mark, and now after it was dormant for a while, able to get a successful play here on first down.
Simple read. Just he reads the end just like he did right there, and he's pulling the ball. That's not something that just happens overnight. He's got to really work on that, and Davis has really mastered that, pulling that ball.
And that mesh point's always dangerous. That's the fumble point there, and it looked like Ruiz wanted that ball, didn't it?
That's what I said. It takes a lot of practice, and, you know, it seems and looks great on paper until the 10,000-hour rule. I think they've probably done that in their sleep.
Shane, what's it like for you to be home back in the state of West Virginia?
You know, it's really great. I mean, you know, it's very humbling, and to be able to think that coming back here 30 years ago where I received my degrees and helped run this athletic department is something that I don't take lightly, and I want to make West Virginia fans and student athletes very proud.
Oh, boy, Patterson, that was right in the breadbasket for DeMond Patterson. Very well-thrown ball by Ricky Davis. Incomplete. And I would imagine, look, you have your passion wherever you are, Alabama, wherever you've been previously, but I think coming home, that it's got to add a little something to it, doesn't it?
It really does. You know, my family's from the state, still lives here, closer to my parents and my brothers and sisters and nieces and nephews, and so it's really special to be back here in Morgantown and, you know, help this university, which everybody loves in this state, to try to make this one of the best programs within the Big 12 as well as nationally.
Second and 10. Davis back under pressure looking and just had to throw that one away, intended for Ruiz. You know, a big thing that a lot of fans look at is future scheduling. How do you figure that out? There's a lot of moving parts involved there, isn't there?
There's a lot of moving parts. And, you know, a lot of people question about scheduling FCS opponents, and it shows you right here Youngstown State is a very well-coached program. But, you know, what I've looked at, you know, Rob is looking at, you know, what we do in the Big 12, obviously looking at scheduling with the Pitts and the Maryland's and the Penn States in the future years and Virginia Tech's to keep, you know, it close to home a little bit. Then you have teams like Youngstown State as well coming into Morgantown.
Third and 10, Mountaineers looking for a stop. Out in the flats, Ruiz is going to be hit by Crawford and dropped. Shane Lyons, thank you very much. Appreciate your time.
Rob, thank
Continued
you.
Continued good luck.
Absolutely.
The upgrades, looking forward
thank
to that.
You.
A lot of great improvements being made to the West Virginia facilities here for the Mountaineers in a variety of sports, not just the big revenue generators, but the Aquatic Center as well. So good to see for all the future student-athletes and current student-athletes here in Morgantown. Schuler back to kick. Jennings back to receive. Jenny's going to let that one go, and it's going to trickle into the end zone. So the Mountaineers will have the ball at the 20-yard line with a 7-point lead when we return. 7:32 remaining in the second quarter. Four-game series against the Reds. Skyler Howard back. Late blitz coming. Throws incomplete. Mark, you know, again, we talked about the timeouts used by Bo Pelini in that first half. Maybe tipping points in the game. Jameel Smith had a chance to pick one off in the end zone. Instead, the Mountaineers score a touchdown. You get the sense this is an important moment in the game right now.
I think so. This drive is really important. I was actually going to bring that up. If West Virginia can somehow put a drive together and go up 14, that's going to change the whole complexion.
But Gibson is hit and dropped immediately. Really fine defensive play by Kenny Bishop, who read that right away and jumped it.
Yeah, number one thing is you got to be able to cut that receiver or defensive back or put a body on him, and or that play is dead. But third and 12, this is the same situation Youngstown State was just in. You don't want these third and long situations. Just a lot of bad things can happen.
Well, Derek Rivers, 24 sacks in his last 24 games. The Mountaineers have done a nice job blocking him. He's run wide again, and now Howard tucks. Howard looking for first down yardage, and he's able to get across the 30 before he's slung down by Leroy Alexander. And aching ribs or no aching ribs for Skyler Howard, he's able to pick up the first down.
Well, you got to give him a lot of credit. You know, he's sore with these ribs, but he's tucking it when he has to today and making good decisions. And you know, getting a first down like that is huge, because I know Youngstown State, if West Virginia can score here, they don't want to get in that shootout game. They wanted to play just like they did in the first half.
Howard will give to Shell. Shell picking his way forward. And Shell will get out to about the 33-yard line. He'll pick up three, maybe the 34. Three-yard gain in that first down run.
Staying between the tackles and second and seven. That's not gonna hurt you. Not a negative play. And the playbook expands when you have second and six, second and seven.
It was Jalen Powell, the Michigan State transfer, who came up with a stop in West Virginia. Huddling up. Variety of different paces they've played at and can play at. Here's a give to Kennedy McCoy. McCoy across the 40, very, very close to first down yardage. It looks from the spot at the top of the screen like they're going to have it, and they are going to say, move the chains.
It's a cover two look, and that's what you need to get 6-7 yards whenever they want to play cover two. You got to force them to single high, and then the way Skyler's throwing these deep balls today, you can take your shots again. So you just got to force Youngstown State to get out of that cover, too, if they want to throw the ball again.
And we can see one of the Youngstown State players can't see the numbers, is down. And, you know, West Virginia able to use more two-back looks than we've seen in the past. And the reason for that is because they feel comfortable with Kennedy McCoy being able to come in. They used to have with Smallwood and Shell, and they just had the two backs. Mark was, you know, they didn't want them both exhausted out there, so they didn't show a lot of two-back. But now that you have that third back, the capability to do that, and they really think Kennedy McCoy is going to be a great player.
It's just a nice luxury to have, and especially on a day like today when it's that hot down there, you can keep three backs fresh. You know, Youngstown State, they're beat up at the running back position, so it's definitely an advantage for West Virginia today to have that luxury.
That was Avery Moss, the Nebraska transfer, who checks out. Johnson Louagine comes in, number 33, to play the right defensive end position. And now they're saying the last play under review is they want to check the spot. So they had some time during that injury to take a look at it and didn't avail themselves of that situation. So they're going to check the spot on Kennedy McCoy's second down run to see if it was enough for a first down. As we're going to give you a couple looks at it and let you decide. I'm done trying to decide. 1 for 3 today.
It's like the 40 and a half, I would say.
That's what it looks
about
like to me,
is.
But I don't want to.
Hey, referees want camera time too, so he had a wait.
I don't want to encroach on your 2-1 record here today. I'm 1-2.
Oh, they got it about the 41. Okay.
Yeah. Will they overturn this for a half a yard? You think? Because a half a yard, it's not a first down.
I'm gonna say no.
156 yards rushing for West Virginia. Boy, that is awfully close. One more look here. Kennedy McCoy, a true freshman from Lexington, North Carolina. That aerial view. I'm going to dip my toes into the water again, Mark, and say that I think it's short of a first down.
Okay.
See if I can go 1 for 4. That's 250. That's not very good.
Well, if they overturn this, I'm going to keep an eye on Coach Holgerson and his reaction down there, because I don't think he'll be too excited. Like we said, this is such an important drive for Youngstown State, you know, to hopefully, you know, keep them, West Virginia, out of the end zone, because they said they do not want to get in a shootout game. And if you can get up two scores, guys are going to start getting tired with this heat. You know, it's exactly what West Virginia wants.
After further review, the ball will be spotted at the 40-and-a-half yard line, which brings up third down.
2-2.
You were right. I said 40-and-a-half, and then I said they won't overturn it, so I kind of contradicted myself there, don't I?
Not going to give you credit for it. Marked at the 40-and-a-half, and it'll be third down. West Virginia 8 of 11 on third down. This is obviously the very definition of a manageable third down situation. About a foot to go.
Maybe they'll do that quarterback sneak deal again.
That was a very interesting and creative way to run a quarterback sneak.
Well, right there, it looks like 2-3 techniques. He could do it.
Youngstown State showing pressure. They'll give to McCoy, who finds a crease. Kennedy McCoy. And McCoy inside the 40 and down to the 38-yard line before he is tripped up. So the freshman found a seam and picked up the first down and much more.
Yeah, they were shooting two safeties up in the A-gaps, and Schuyler looked to the sideline. They checked to that run, and, you know, that's just great game planning there.
Big gaping hole. Leroy Alexander with the stop. Savon Smith, after that 22-yard run, is down behind the play. And we mentioned it is extremely hot. This looks like cramping. It looked like he was pointing to his calf.
That's exactly what it is. You just stretch those calves, and I would be surprised if he's the last one that has the cramps. Well, the good thing for West Virginia, if you're a fan of theirs, is they're in the shade now. And Youngstown State is looking right into the sun, so that could be an advantage for West Virginia right now.
As we mentioned, 90 degrees at kickoff with the chance of the sun down on that turf and the humidity making it feel like 130 degrees down there.
And those cramps, they're a lot like getting seasick. Once it starts, they don't like to go away, so this could be start to become an issue.
Smith able to jog off. Boy, sometimes if you haven't had a cramp in a while, you forget just how painful they can be.
Well, I don't think you and I are out of the woods, so if one of us drops or if anyone hears a noise, that could be us cramping up here.
As I've gotten older, I've moved to the lack of muscle, and you have to have a muscle, right, to get a cramp, I believe, don't you?
I wouldn't know. I never had muscles.
So first down after that 22-yard run by McCoy. Wellman is the lone setback. Howard will move him from his right to his left. Now he'll give to Elijah Wellman off the right side, and Wellman will barrel forward across the 35 and down close to the 34-yard line. Wellman had a trio of carries last week against Missouri.
Yeah, nice run. Good positive run of Youngstown State's going to stay in this cover too. I think you're going to see more of it.
A fake to him this time and throw out and complete. And it's White. White is flung down near the first down yardage marker. Right at the first down yardage marker.
White's a good-looking receiver here. And I like how he catches the balls with his hands. And the more receivers touch the ball when he's a young kid, the more confidence they get. And it's amazing what just catching the ball does for their confidence. And that's everything with a receiver.
And quarterback sneak as Howard picks up the first down. We talked about confidence earlier today. Caron White with his first touchdown reception, so that's a confidence booster. And here's that quarterback sneak again.
Yeah, I think they saw something on film. They're really not lining up a nose tackle over the center on these short third and downs, so another good game plan.
Tripped out to Jennings. Jennings will get across the 15 and will pick up first down yardage again. Mark out of bounds at the 14-yard line.
Yeah, the key on these look screens is catch the ball and get going, because the more you dance around, there's eight other white jerseys coming. So he does a great job catching the ball, getting yards.
Devontae Mathis, good job of blocking as well. There's a give to Wellman. Avery Moss has checked back in and makes the stop right at the line of scrimmage. No gain for Wellman.
There's certainly no fight being given up by the D-line here in Youngstown State. They're still playing really hard to the run.
Howard now will keep off the right side. Howard will burrow forward down to the 5-yard line, just short of a first down.
Nice design play there. They ran this look screen a couple plays, and they faked it there and had a nice off-tackle play with the quarterback.
Pretty much as good as a block, right? You freeze those outside defensive backs. They can't come in and help out.
Sure, yeah. You got the linebacker who's in no man's land. He doesn't know if he has to run out to the receivers or stay inside, and well designed.
Third down. Shell in, gets the carry off the left side, and Russell Shell will barrel into the end zone from 5 yards out. Touchdown, Mountaineers.
Just a great run. He's so hard to bring down between the tackles, like I've been saying all game. And we do have a flag. I think they may have called holding.
Holding, 62 of the offense. 10-yard penalty, replay third down.
You know, just a tough, tough run by Shell there. And just when you think all the momentum's going to West Virginia, one holding play can hurt that.
Kyle Bosch called for the hold right there in the center of your screen on Lamont Ragland, who's trying to come down.
Saw a little hands to the face, and maybe that's why he called it. I'm not. You could call that every play if you wanted.
And you talked about red zone and some of the things that happen. And right there, you've got a touchdown in the red zone. We'll see what happens now. But a little bit more difficult here now, backed up to the 16-yard line. Howard back. Blitz coming. Howard rolls out to his right, in trouble, and will simply throw it away. So once again, a touchdown comes off the board. Jameel Smith with the pressure. And the Mountaineers will have to try a field goal. And keep in mind, again, Mike Molina, after hitting the first 4 field goals against Missouri, missed a field goal here at the end of the first half.
It is amazing when you have all these questions about red zone, just little things like that happen. The execution was just the way you drew it up. Great run by Shell, and a flag's on the ground. And it's just amazing how when it rains, it pours.
32-yard field goal attempt. Under 3 minutes remaining in the third. Kick is up, and this one by Molina is right down the center. So a 2-score lead for the Mountaineers. They wanted the touchdown. It's taken off the board. They get the field goal and lead by a 24-14 score.
It is to have Bailey back and around the team. While Bailey has stated that he is grateful for the opportunity to heal and that his playing career is not over yet. Guys?
Meg, thanks very much. And boy, what a tragedy for Stedman Bailey. And about 24, 25, 26 credits short of his degree, so he's going to be working on that. There he is. He's been associated with the team, but still working, trying to get that piece of paper. Dana Hogerson encouraging him to do that. He's looking on after his Mountaineers complete a 14-play, 65-yard drive. Time of possession, we talked about that, Mark. Now just about even in this game as the Mountaineers have rallied to take a 10-point lead.
Yeah, I know they only got 3 points there, but that was a impressive drive until the holding call. But
again, we mentioned that this is not a quick strike, necessarily quick strike Youngstown State team. Is Crawford doing a nice job in coverage, batting that away? And so, you know, if you're going to take a long time scoring, and they did have the long touchdown pass earlier, but mostly they're a methodical type of team, they're going to need maybe to score some points on this very drive.
Yeah, he got away with one there. I'm glad Ricky didn't throw a pick there, because that was the cover two look, and the out can be a dangerous pass with that coverage.
A White coming up showing blitz. Now he'll back, drop back. Now another look for Davis. Cat and mouse game. Davis looking, throwing, and complete. Boy, almost undercutting that, looking for the interception. Instead, the completion out to Stephon Derrick as White, again, dropping back and nearly there for the pick.
Same exact play, just to the opposite side as the play before. Cover two again, and really, really dangerous pass to throw into that coverage. But like you said, it was a cat and mouse game, and West Virginia won with their disguise.
pickup of just a couple. Need to get out to the 35 to keep the drive alive. Third and seven. Mountaineer showing blitz, crossing pattern, and it is dropped. Incomplete. Crawford coming up hard on Darian Townsend, and Youngstown State will be forced to kick it away.
Just that slant pattern they've been going to all game. Try to get a little pick, but great route recognition. And he probably heard some footsteps. That was the man coverage again. He had 1-on-1 down below. Don't know if that was part of his read. But good job by West Virginia getting off the field.
Schuler back in punt formation. Another high, booming kick. Jennings back at his 26. Jennings makes one man miss. Stays up the center of the field, crosses the 40, gets out to the 43. Nice 17-yard return by Gary Jennings. Get the inside scoop on every WVU football game with Mountaineer Game Day on Root Sports. Tune in Saturdays to preview the Mountaineers' upcoming game and get an in-depth look at their 2016 season. It's all a part of Wild and Wonderful Sports, and it starts Saturdays at 11 on Root Sports.
Well, great field position for West Virginia here. It was one of the very rare three and outs for Youngstown State today.
And McCoy going in motion. Fake. Howard wants to go deep. He's got a man out there. It's Gibson. Floated. Gibson. The grab. Gibson. The touchdown for the Mountaineers. 57 yards. Another long one from Howard to Gibson.
That's the same play they've been running all game. And I mean, the coverage is there. It's cover two, but the safety didn't get off the hash in time. And Gibson's speed. And obviously the perfect throw by Skyler. I mean, the coverage is there. It's just Gibson just running by guys and Skyler putting it right on the money. Just with the docket order for West Virginia.
Well, for the third time in his career, not counting that Cactus Bowl, but in regular season play, Skyler Howard has thrown for four touchdown passes. Did it last year against Maryland and at Baylor. Mike Molina on to try the extra point.
These big plays have really hurt Youngstown State today on defense. And, you know, they're doing a good job inside, but they're setting these up and I think the speed's just a little much for them outside. Yeah, just a fake up the middle, and again, the safety just doesn't get over in time, and the speed of Gibson just was too much.
Well, one of the other things, too, and the speed's wonderful, but, boy, those have been three long throws right on the money by Skyler Howard catching his receivers in stride.
I mean, you couldn't have thrown them better, and also his fade route was perfect. So he's been, other than one or two throws, he went a little behind. I mean, he's been right on the money, and that's impressive with his rib deal. And he gets the week off next week before they play BYU, so that's the perfect time to have that bye week.
Mountaineers coming out with a very strong third quarter play. Remember, Youngstown State got the ball first, but West Virginia's been able to really bottle up the Penguins' offense here in this second half, beginning to pull away here into third, up 31-14. And Molina set for the run-up and the kick. There's Townsend. He'll take it a yard deep in the end zone. Across the 10, across the 20, picks his way forward out to the 24-yard line where he is dropped by Schuler. And you take a look at West Virginia's first-round pick since 2012. How about Carl Joseph, Kevin White? We talked about the other two Whites currently playing for the Mountaineers, the seventh overall selection by the Bears. Obviously injured a year ago, Tavon Austin, taken eighth overall by the Rams in 2013. And then on the defensive side, Bruce Irvin by the Seahawks, 15th overall. The Mountaineers continuing to churn out top players, and is it wide receiver you now? Look at the excellent receivers that have entered the NFL from West Virginia and some other good ones on this roster now as we take a look at the run to Tevin McCastaboy. Strung out and down he goes. That was White and Christian Brown. So White and Brown meet to form the colorful tackle on that play.
Yeah, this is definitely the kind of game that I think Youngstown State wanted to avoid. They wanted to play the possession game like they did in the first half perfectly, but now I don't think West Virginia is going to give up any big plays and going to force Youngstown State to throw the ball.
Davis back, looking, throwing, complete over the middle. Oh, boy, a big hit, and now the ball comes out late, and it's going to be incomplete, intended for Alvin Bailey. And, man, was he hit by Jeremy Tyler, who the Mountaineers say is their most athletic defensive back, beginning to get some NFL attention, and they're going to like this hit.
Yeah, with cover two down the middle is usually right up, you know, the most open putt. But you get hits like that, it's going to make these receivers think twice about heading in there, and they're going to keep their head on a swivel. So just big hit, and you could feel the momentum switching.
Third and 11. Mountaineers rushing three. Davis throwing, complete, and this time his receiver hangs on. That is Damon Patterson, the junior college transfer. And that is enough for a first down for Youngstown State. 16-yard pickup.
That was more of a prevent kind of defense. They had three safeties and five underneath, and there's not many holes, but well-designed play and good throw. Good job by the offensive line. That's a long developing play, and for them to give him that much time, Ricky Davis should probably thank them.
Trips to the left in this formation, receiver to the right. Waning seconds of the third quarter. Davis will keep. Davis to the outside, and he's dragged down by Rasul Douglas, but a nice first down gain of about 8 yards for Ricky Davis.
As I read off tackle again, and they really do that well. He's been real effective getting 6-7 yards on each attempt.
Well, every time you think Youngstown State might be in some trouble, they get off the mat and come up swinging, and they're doing that here now in this final drive of the third quarter that will extend on into the fourth quarter of play. But it has been a very good third quarter for the Mountaineers. West Virginia and Youngstown State were tied at the break, 14-14. West Virginia has now scored 28 unanswered points. Down at one point, concluding play, Central Michigan tops number 22 Oklahoma State. Ohio dropping Kansas as well. So West Virginia looking to avoid the upsets. And I guess it's become cliche a little bit to talk about upsets. And, you know, there aren't that many upsets anymore in college football. But anytime you see a school from a MAC against a Power 5 team, a school from an FCS moving up to the FBS ranks, you're a little surprised to see, you know, the bigger school on the short end of the stick.
Yeah, it's amazing that Oklahoma State came today, but, you know, kids that want to play right away now, they go to these smaller schools because they'd rather play 4 years and sit for three and play one.
Play action pass. Davis looking in trouble. Uh-oh. Oh, my. Just able to get out of it, and wow, that was very close. Xavier Preston there. I don't know if Davis intentionally threw that too high, but avoided what could have been a disaster.
He takes a really big shot here at the end of the play, and like you said, it's really lucky to get away with that one. That could have easily gone the other way for six.
Second and 10 after the incompletion. There's Xavier Preston. Very, very talented junior linebacker. Split backs, give up the middle. And it's Ruiz, again trying to get into mark that third and manageable. Al-Rashid Benton on the tackle, but nice, good, solid four-yard gain. Going to bring up third and a short six.
Third and five, third and six. You got to be thinking if you're Bo, if you're going to go for it here, if this is two-down territory or if this is just if it's too early.
That affects your play call here on third down, right?
You could still run the ball if you're going to go for it on fourth down, too.
Washington is showing some pressure. Here they come on the blitz. Davis steps up, throws out in the flat, incomplete. And we saw softer coverage before, Mark, it seems. And this time, Rasul Douglas really closing fast on the outside there.
Yeah, they're really starting to sit. I think that comes because the defensive line, the linebackers are starting to get in there and get hits on the quarterback. So in the first half, he had a lot more time to sit back there and throw the ball. But with the pressure coming now, he's got to get rid of it quick, and the corners really don't have to give that cushion.
So they will punt it away. Schuler back in punt formation. And he's going to aim one for the corner. Ooh, beautifully played down at the one-yard line. What a punt by Schuler as we take a look at Skylar Howard after that 45-yard punt and his work today. Mark, very composed. We know the ribs may be an issue, but great job throwing some of these long balls today.
Those deep balls have been nothing but spectacular today. I mean, every one of these gets better. I mean, the speed of Gibson there. Another great ball to the corner here. There it is again, Gibson speed. And the balls, I mean, they're not easy balls to throw. They look like it, but he's perfect rhythm, perfect air, and letting them run underneath it.
Mountaineers will have the ball at the one-yard line. Give off the right side, Crawford, and Crawford is taken down. Nice open field tackle by Jamar Pinnock.
Good play there. Just get a little bit of breathing room. The last thing you would want is a safety here.
Look at the difference in the first half and then the third quarter for the Mountaineers, scoring as many points, actually more points, obviously, and racking up those yards as well.
So I think the time of possession has been huge, too, in the third quarter, the way they were able to flip it.
Play action pass. Howard looking, throwing it. Oh, almost intercepted, then almost caught as well. 50-50 ball as David Rivers and White were battling for it.
Yeah, play action. Pass out of the end zone. Couldn't see that coming, but he does a good job getting rid of it. But, wow. White has his long arm, so that was a good play just to play a little bit of defense there.
They've had a couple of opportunities, Youngstown State, to make some plays defensively. Not to undercut their effort by any means. Hit a very, very solid ball game now. Third and eight. Howard will give to Crawford off the left side. And Crawford, boy, squirts out of that massive humanity and is able to pick up a couple more yards, but short of the first down. And so West Virginia will have to punt it away here.
Again, I think getting 3-4 yards there is good. You give your punter a little more room in the end zone. He's not, you practice, you know, the 15-yard snap, and then all of a sudden you're taking it from 10 yards. That could cause an issue, but good play call there. And like I said, kickers, you never know what's going through their minds. So to him to be back to a normal position is good.
Billy Kinney back to punt it away. Alvin Bailey back deep. Kinney just hammers one. It's Townsend back deep. Townsend at the 42. And tries to stay on his feet. And boy, when he cuts back in, he cuts back into a mass of blue and gold. And down he goes at the 41-yard line. The kicking of Billy Kinney, the Morgantown native.
You hope it's just a cramp. He's only had to play 3 or 4 plays.
Here's a handoff to Ruiz. Ruiz finding some room. Ruiz spun down, but gets down inside the 45, down to the 43. Douglas with the stop.
Douglas with the stop.
Speaking of kickers, I used to have to watch Youngstown State with my time with the Rams because our kicker, Jeff Money Wilkins, was with us for years, and he's a Youngstown State grad, and he used to have us watch them in the locker room.
With apologies to Paul McFadden, I think Jeff Wilkins, 2003 Pro Bowler, probably the most prominent of the Youngstown State kickers that have made it to the NFL. Zach Kennedy might be the next, but Wilkins, an awfully good one.
He was really good. He's actually recovering from a leg injury from a flag football game we had 6 weeks ago, so get better there, Jeff, if you're watching.
Two tight end look. Second and seven. Fake to Ruiz. Rolling. This is Hosick in the game now. Nearly intercepted. So Trent Hosick has checked in at the quarterback position. Douglas nearly got his hands on it. Hosick, a junior college transfer from Arizona Western, who began his career at Missouri.
Had a roll out to get him going in the game for his first pass. And that ball should have been intercepted.
Hosick 2 for 2 last week in his first action as Youngstown State won comfortably 45-10 over Duquesne. A third down for Hosick. Mountaineers showing blitz. Hosick will change the play. Here they come again. Now the flag, and it's going to be a delay of game.
It's a real tough situation to come into.
Delay a game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Down 17 points and thrown into the fire, but this is where you get better when you haven't played a whole lot. You might as well learn on the run.
Third and 12, back to the 45-yard line. Need to get to the 33 of West Virginia. Hosek back. Blitz coming. Steps up. Hosek moving out to his right. Tucks it and is trying to run for the first down and rounds the corner and is going to be very close to first down yardage. Down at the 36. Probably close enough at least where you'd think about going for it here on fourth down.
Defensive coordinator Gibson brought the house there that they were doing in the first half a bunch, and nice job to avoid it and get some positive yards. I think we got some more cramping going on.
Fourth down. Yep, we sure do. It looks like it's Brock Eisenruth, the right guard from Johnstown, PA. But it's not Brock Eisenruth, it's Justin Spencer. Yeah, Eisenruth not healthy enough to play today. Spencer from Indiana, Pennsylvania. Another WPIL product.
Number 61, Justin Spencer. Shaking off the play.
And now the teams will avail themselves of that to get together and have a little confab. Fourth and three. And you would think this is, again, go for a territory here. I suppose you could try a long one by Zach Kennedy. You need three scores, but they're going to keep the offense out on the field. Ruiz will come out. Hosek under center. Youngstown State down 31-14. 11:05 and counting remaining here in the fourth quarter. Now West Virginia wants to talk things over. Tony Gibson, the defensive coordinator, will rally the team around him to talk over this fourth down play.
There was a little confusion up top with the two defensive backs.
So Youngstown State going for it on fourth down, 31-14, West Virginia. Fourth down, Youngstown State going for it. Hosek back, throwing out into the flat, and it is complete. Is it enough for a first down? It is. As Alvin Bailey makes the grab, Rasul Douglas in coverage, and Youngstown State picks up the first down, 2-for-2 on fourth down now this season.
That was not an easy throw from the left hash all the way outside. Puts it right on the money. In college, the hashes are a lot wider than the NFL, so I used to dread those kind of throws, but impressive throw on fourth down.
Hosek gives to Ruiz. Ruiz, a crease off the left side. Ruiz trying to bounce it outside, will be wrestled down by Justin Arndt. But a good, solid pickup on first down. And we saw some holes here in the first half as well, Mark.
It's the same play they've been running. And there's holes. And the third quarter, they hiccuped a little bit, but seems like they got it going again here in the fourth quarter. And I'll say this about them. They're not giving up. They're sticking with their game plan. And I don't know how this one's going to end up, but this is a really good football team.
Rank number 22 in the FCS ranks. Two tight end look. And a second down. Hosek will fake. Hosek keeps on the option. Hosek picking his way towards the middle of the field and finally rolled down at the 17-yard line. First down for the Penguins.
They definitely got two quarterbacks that can run. I know that. And after that last throw, they might have two quarterbacks that could play for them too. Just a heck of a job with the fake and getting a big chunk. That's what they need, chunks right now if they want to have any chance in this game. 3 and 4 yards will not do it.
That was Justin Arndt in pursuit. Part of the Pro Football Focus Team of the Week in college football last week. You give just a short gain that time for Ruiz down to the 15-yard line. Actually, that's Tevin McCaster who's checked into the game.
West Virginia's still playing 1-on-1 outside. They're actually giving that cushion a little, so I don't know if this is time for Youngstown State to maybe take a shot to the end zone if they give them the same coverage to try to get a quick six, but probably have to pick up the pace here starting a little bit here.
Under 15 on the play clock on a second and 8. Hosek now changing things, each team gesturing. Hosek wants to throw. Now he's going to keep. Hosek to the 10. Hosek inside the 5. And Hosek lowers his shoulder and gets in for the score. Trent Hosek, no. They said he stepped out of bounds at the 5. So Hosek looked like he was in the end zone. No, he is in the end zone. I beg your pardon. No, I never saw a single official call this a touchdown. Have you?
I think he's on the 1 or 2. Or maybe I'm wrong. No, touchdown.
No, it's a touchdown.
I didn't see it either. Just a great job by him pulling that ball and making this read coming off the bench. That's a tough run right there. You don't like to take those shots, but that's exactly what Youngstown State needed.
So Hosek does scamper in for the score. Zach Kennedy on to try the extra point. The kick is up. And the kick is good, and the lead is back down to 10. A 9-play, 57-yard drive, and it's West Virginia 31, Youngstown State 21, after Hosek's touchdown run for the Penguins. Is cut to 10, 31-21. Kennedy with the boot. And it's going to go deep into the end zone, so Shelton Gibson will watch it sail over his head, and the Mountaineers will have the ball at the 25-yard line. And so Youngstown State, if people were expecting them to roll over, they were mistaken.
Really impressive that Trent Hosek could come in off the bench like this. I much preferred when I was starting to be in the backup. I was 1 year in Baltimore as a backup, and you didn't know when you're going in, but you had to prepare the same. So for him to come in and that fourth down pass across from the hash was really, really impressive. And I mean, the run was something else too, but that fourth down pass was crucial.
First down for the Mountaineers. This is Shell off the right side, and he's dropped after a 1 yard gain. Wanted to ask you, Mark, what are the biggest, you know, now it's become more in vogue to have two quarterbacks. It wasn't really when you were playing. So maybe guys have planned moments where they know they're going to come in. But what is the biggest challenge if you don't know you're going to come into a game?
If you don't know, it's kind of not like baseball where they give you as much time as you want to warm up. It's football, it's pretty much you're coming in, everyone's been playing 2 or 3 quarters and they're loose, and today you wouldn't be cold, but your muscles aren't warmed up.
Power back out in the flat, and Shell.
And another point.
Normally sure-handed, drops that one.
And another point with that is, you know, the quarterback who's been playing the whole game, he's seen these coverages over and over again, and they start to get a feel. It's a different view from the sideline, so you're coming in and you're learning on the fly, because pitchers don't do it justice. You don't want to say this is real, real important for West Virginia on this third down, but I think it puts a little pressure back on them if Youngstown State can hold them and get the ball back.
Third and 9. Howard back. Pressure coming. Going to loft one deep. Good coverage downfield, and this time Smith is here. Wow, they are going to call this pass interference. It was David Rivers in coverage on White. Oh, boy. Wow, Rivers looked like he was in excellent position. This will be interesting on the replay.
Pass interference. Defense, number 31. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Yeah, we'll have to see this. It had to be his right hand because I really didn't see much either.
Wow. That's if you're Youngstown State, that is a very, very tough call to swallow.
Tell you what, though, another great ball by Skyler. I mean, the ball was right there, gave his receiver an opportunity, and that's all you can ask for.
And there's another flag now over by the Youngstown State sidelines. Eddie Shelton and his crew getting together. Bo Pelini obviously not very happy. Let's see if they can get things sorted out here for us.
We'll need that shit right now.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. Head coach of Youngstown State. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Bo Pelini clearly frustrated, and so now one penalty on top of the other, the automatic first down, and now a 15-yard penalty marched off, and the ball will be set down at the 44-yard line of Youngstown State. Boy, that is tough, and you can understand the frustration. Looked like a very, very good defensive play. You're going to get the ball back with about 8 minutes left, a chance, you know, to cut into this 10-point deficit. Instead, now West Virginia, the automatic first down, and now 15 more after the penalty on Bo Pelini.
A third and long, that's a tough pill to swallow, and Coach Olgerson's been getting after them pretty well, too. So, like you said, that's a tough call.
Pass out in the flat to Shelton Gibson. Gibson will struggle forward for 3 or 4 yards on that first down play. Armand Delavade came from the inside linebacker position to help make the stop.
You can see right now, Youngstown State, I think they're going to start trying to tackle the ball a little bit. So they might not be out of the realm of possibilities for them to break another long run or so, because when you start trying to strip the ball and not working on your tackling, you know, but there's really no options with 7.5 to go.
By the way, Skyler Howard now a career high in passing yards. The previous number was 359 versus Georgia Southern. Now at 360 yards as Jalen Powell down evidently with a cramp as well. And it is a busy day for the training staff on both teams, running out there with that water to keep everybody hydrated, something you mentioned even before the opening kickoff. This is the day to be keeping those fluids running through you.
Yeah, and like I mentioned earlier, I think this second half is a huge advantage for West Virginia having the shade the whole half. I mean, I guarantee it's 20, 30 degrees cooler on their bench. And I'm sure that's by design. When you design a fielder, you pick the sides. But those Youngstown State guys, you look over there, they're just getting baked.
Maybe a little bit better in November, right?
Maybe a little
waning
better.
Sun, maybe you're over there a little warmer, perhaps. But not today.
Not today. And these cramps are starting to mount up, and it's pretty much been all Youngstown State guys cramping, minus the West Virginia kicker cramping.
Well, we saw the hill here behind the punter. Yeah, Billy Kinney saw the hill here behind you guys. Had to run up in the days of Don Nealon. Coach Nealon popping by to pay you a visit as well.
Yes, I do not miss that, the Law School Hill, we called it. It was spent a lot of hours there.
Out to White. White heads up field. And White is going to pick up first down yardage. You mentioned trying to tackle the ball. That was exactly what Shamil Smith was trying to do there.
You're going to see some, it's going to look like poor tackling, but this is what they're coached to do right now, is try to go get that ball, and get a turnover. You mentioned Coach Nealon. He's having a roast here November 4th in West Virginia, where all of us are going to come back to it. And Coach Trickett stopped in. Or Tressel stopped in to
Jim Tressel.
The box. We had two legends up here during halftime.
That was pretty neat, wasn't it? Jim Tressel, of course, at Ohio State, now the athletic director at Youngstown State. Now here's Howard with a keep. And again, that's as Jalen Powell back in makes the stop. That's pretty gutsy when you know a guy's got, you know.
Now he knows he's going to get hit running in there, and that is gutsy. And this bye week, next week, couldn't have come at a better time for Skyler, at least.
Have the rib injury whatever the damage is there that forced him out of the game last week against Nebraska. Had to manage that for him.
Yeah, there's really nothing you can do. I played with three or four, and they want to shoot it up, but they can't puncture your lung, and it's just a miserable injury because there's nothing you can do.
There's Wellman with a carry. Wellman hit in the hole.
I think my first time I broke, I went and
now
got
for a first down.
X-rays, and they said they were broken. I said, okay, now what? They said, well, there's nothing we can do. So from that point on in my career, I never got them X-rayed because you're going to get the same result. There's no cure.
That doesn't sound like a lot of fun to me, playing with broken ribs.
Yes, and not being able to say you have broken ribs because you don't want the opposing team.
Sure.
Not a fun 8 weeks. Oh
boy, what a beautifully designed play. Touchdown pass. And that is the first touchdown for the freshman, Kennedy McCoy. They've been going to that wide receiver screen mark all game. Now they release McCoy, and it's an easy pitch and catch.
They use that stack formation out there with the receivers, and it worked perfectly. Great design. Just miscommunication with the corners. They both took the same person. So you do that, and you do it, and you do it. And when you stack a receiver, there's really no X or Y. They really can confuse the corners and work perfectly.
Molina on now to try the extra point for West Virginia. Again, Youngstown State thought they'd stop this drive. Pass interference call keeps it alive. Molina, extra point kick is up. It is good. And the Mountaineers capping off a 7-play, 75-yard drive with a 21-yard touchdown pass from Skyler Howard to freshman Kennedy McCoy his first career touchdown. Mountaineers up 38-21. Record heading into the conference portion of their slate. Here's the kick, and it is taken by Townsend at the 5. The 10 tries to get to the edge and nearly gets there, but is going to be upended as he gets out to the 23-yard line. And Mark, take us through this last touchdown pass from Howard to McCoy.
Yeah, that's that stack formation I was talking about. They've been running this look screen, just miscommunication with the corners. And that's honestly some of the toughest throws you have and the toughest catches because it's so wide open. But like I said, just a good read by Skyler because sometimes the ball's already out. But for him to take a peek there, just well-designed and you know, that's something that you'll see them go to the rest of the year, too, with that stack formation.
Howard's fifth touchdown pass, Matt, that is a new career high in regular season play for him. You mentioned he had those 5 last year in the bowl game. Osick will give. And that's McCastro. He'll pick up a few out across 25 to about the 28-yard line. And, you know, you mentioned that setting up a play. You're trying to train the defense, right? They keep coming up, coming up, coming up, and they want to help snuff things out, maybe make a play, and you're able to capitalize on that by leaking somebody out.
Yeah, it's just Pavlov's dog. You keep doing it, and you hope for the big hit. So, you know, some of these kids are 19, 20 years old. They're not getting paid to play this this game, and so it takes a lot of film study to recognize things.
Here's Hosek now in the option. Pitches out, McCastro, stutter step, taken down by Al-Rashid Benton, but not until he picks up a first down.
Just the speed option they've been running all game, and they're sticking with it, and they're not. Doesn't seem like they're going to change to a pass in every down. They're just going to stick with what they're doing, and we'll have to speed up a little bit.
Ooh, Hosek, high snap. Looking, throwing out. Oh, boy. Dangerous pass, but a great move by McCastro, able to hang on to that ball. What concentration and pick up 8 yards before Kaiser White can make the stop.
Yeah, just a tough catch knowing you're going to get it. Fortunately, he was able to avoid it, but great job by Hosek getting that ball. That could have easily been a fumble for a touchdown, but to get 8 yards there, if you're a Youngstown State fan, that was a 1 in 10 times deal.
Pride themselves on toughness in Newcastle. That's a tough play by Tevin McCastro there. And McCastro will get the hand up. Handoff, he'll pick up the first down. Stopped by Jared Harper. Boy, they're just hammering away here, Youngstown State.
Hammer away, and just hope they hit a big one. I think that's the goal right now. They're going to stick with what they're doing and take a shot. But you'd have to think West Virginia is just going to stay in a cover two kind of show and not let the big play happen. But I know how coaches are. They don't want to give up the yards and use the cheap yards at the end because they count too.
Under 3:45 remaining here on the snap of that ball. Now Hosek looking to get outside, and Hosek will scurry across the 50 into West Virginia territory, out of bounds at about the 49-yard line.
Nice job by his receiver, Patterson, there protecting him. He was running to the sideline, and he took on a pretty big linebacker to keep the quarterback Hosek from taking a hit. So I know when they watch game film, he'll thank him for that.
Someone was going to take a blow, and Patterson had the option, so he took it upon himself, right?
Took it for him for his QB. That'll turn into him getting a couple more looks, I think.
Hosek back, looking, stepping up, throwing late and complete over the middle. First down. Once again, Alvin Bailey on the receiving end for Youngstown State.
Yeah, I know he can run, but he has some pretty good pocket awareness, too, just the way he's shifting around with the pocket. And doing a pretty nice job moving them down the field again.
Hosek over the middle, complete. Finds his tight end, Jacob Wood.
Hosek's pass complete to 88.
He's taking what they're giving him, and
that's
all he can do right now. You don't want to force the ball and have turnovers, and that's just demoralizing. So, you know, it might not be enough time to win this one, but he's doing what he was coached to do, and he's doing a great job.
Osick back over the middle. This one is read and picked off by Al-Rashid Benton. Benton calling for some blockers. Instead is upended by McCaster, but Al-Rashid Benton with the interception for the Mountaineers. The first of his career.
The minute I say that they get a turnover, but, you know, at the same time, you got to make a play. He had two guys to the left. He's trying to look him off to the right side of the field, but great play there, just reading his eyes when he came back.
The Mountaineers come up with a turnover. Tony Gibson's going to like that. William Crest Jr. has checked in to play quarterback here for the Mountaineers in the waning moments of the 2012th game for the Mountaineers, in which they have 600 or more yards of total offense under Dana Holgorsen, 602 yards in this game. And here's Crest. He'll keep. Crest banging forward across the 35 out to the 36. He'll pick up 8 on that keeper.
I guess this means that Skyler Howard's done and well-deserved break here. And like I said, he gets that next week off, which will be huge. But, you know, I don't think he could have played better today under the circumstances. And his deep ball is going to be something to see for other teams on film. And really going to have to worry about the deep threat now with the way he's throwing those.
5 touchdown passes for Howard. Crest will keep off the right side. Designed run. He'll get out to the 43-yard line. Move the chains once again for the Mountaineers.
Crest got the keeper.
You know, Crest came in last week and gave up the ball. And, you know, I know he wouldn't do that, but the defense bailed him out. So it's good to him to get back in there, get that bad taste out of his mouth. And, you know, take a couple hits. There's nothing like just getting reps in the game.
Yeah, we can't really simulate it in practice, can you?
No. It's a totally different deal. You're going against ones versus ones in the game, and, you know, they're not your teammates. They're coming at you hard. And a lot of teams, you know, won't even let them hit your quarterback. So this could be the hit first time, you know, he got hit in weeks.
Ball on the ground, but Crest picks it up. Now we'll try to make something out of this broken play. And turning, spinning out to the 45-yard line. He'll pick up a couple. Perhaps one more play for West Virginia.
Situations like this, you just don't want any injuries, but at the same time, you're still coaching your guys. But I'd be surprised if West Virginia just didn't take a couple knees here and be as healthy as they are right now going into that big BYU game.
Cramping issue once again. That's DJ Thomas. Being worked on. And there's Skyler Howard. Has to be happy with his 2-0 start for the Mountaineers. 48 seconds away from officially making it 2-0.
Yeah, I'm just impressed with the way they came out in the second half. It was not looking good at halftime. And, you know, for them to come out and get seven, and for 7-3, then 7, it's... I don't know what coach said at halftime in there, but he got their attention, and both sides of the ball played a lot better.
And what with a team now with a bye week, when do you really begin your focus now on the next opponent and start working maybe on some of the things over this next course week in practice, the things that you need to work on for your team?
Yeah, I think you give your guys a couple days off, but when you come back to work, every coach is different, but you work on your stuff and what you think you need to work on. You know, maybe give the guys a little less reps and let some of the younger guys actually get some work and get everyone healthy.
Results in a 10-second runoff. Yes, elected to take that option. Please set the game clock to 38 seconds. Clock will start on the ready.
So, again, the defensive penalty there to try to prevent teams from using that as a quasi timeout. So they'll take the clock from 48 seconds down to 38 seconds.
And that's the players, but, you know, these coaches, I guarantee, if not tonight, tomorrow, they'll be looking at BYU already.
And the Mountaineers, one more snap, and they will have an 11-game non-conference winning streak. Low snap to Crest. Hand up on the left side, and that will do it. The final run of the game goes to Justin Crawford.
I think we got one more flag.
Oh.
Holding. Number 5 of the offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay second down.
Javon Durant whistled for that one. Dana Holgorsen was already well out onto the field. Now we'll have to retreat for just a couple more seconds. This team will improve to 2-0. Big test coming up after the break against BYU and then on into Big 12 conference play. Really done a nice job in recruiting, beefing up this West Virginia roster, getting him some more depth for the rigors of Big 12 conference play. And the officials conferring. Now they'll jog over to Coach Bo Pelini and explain what they've concluded. Good having you back up here again, Mark.
Thank you for carrying me again.
Been very enjoyable.
I think we got one more penalty left in us here.
You think so? I don't think they'll have to snap it, so I don't think we're going to see another penalty. They're going to let the clock expire. Dana Holgorsen and the Mountaineers, he knew this would be a tough game. You know, FCS, FBS, didn't matter. Bo Pelini's team. They'll look back at a couple of mistakes and a chance to maybe make this uncomfortably close for the Mountaineers. But West Virginia knew they were in a game. I think for both teams, they're going to get what they wanted. For West Virginia, obviously the victory. For Youngstown State, if there was any doubts that under Bo Pelini in year two that they were progressing, I think their performance last week against Duquesne, backed up by this one, is going to erase any doubts.
Sure. I think that third and long call was a big play in the fourth quarter, obviously, and then the unsportsmanlike conduct. But I think both teams can take some positive out of this. You know, the first half for Youngstown State, they're a good football team. They're going to have a great season. And the way West Virginia responded coming out after halftime, I think Coach will be happy with that heading into the bye.
For the Mountaineers, we'll move on, and so will Youngstown State. Boy, they play in a brutally difficult conference that has North Dakota State, the number one team in the country. University of Northern Iowa is tied for third in the polls. They have five ranked teams. It is just doesn't get any easier for Youngstown State moving forward, but you would think, even in a loss, that they're going to have a lot of momentum moving forward in the course of the rest of this season after today's performance.
They'll be able to go back on film and wish they had a couple plays back, but they have nothing to hang their hat on. They play their hearts out. I know there's going to be a lot of sore bodies on that bus leaving this stadium.
Let's go downstairs where Meg Bulger is standing by with Dana Holgorsen for some final thoughts.
All right. Thanks, Rob. Coach, you told me in half that you wanted to convert better on third down. How's 71% for the second half?
Yeah, that's better, obviously. We challenged the guys at halftime. Being a close game in the first half is not surprising. The thing that usually happens with a FCS team like this is you can wear them down in the second half. So I think our guys up front wore them down the second half.
How happy are you with the way your defense battled today?
Well, you know, I don't think Gibby's going to be very happy with what we did defensively. But, you know, we'll take it. We got a bunch of snaps to be able to look at it and see what we got to do to get better.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Rob?
Thanks very much, Meg. And great to have Meg with us as well. I think we need to add some more Bulgers in the future for future telecasts.
We got a couple more. Oh, yeah. A couple of nephews.
We can bring them on. Skyler Howard, 5 touchdowns.